Bruce Scanlon.
Dan.
Jeff Gerstmann.
Reichert.
Whoa, that's pretty cool.
In stereo.
Didn't even plan that. Wow. We got to make good, guys. On the rules of Demo Derby, we're not thorough.
I'm back in the submarine. How did I get here?
No, it's okay. It's okay. No, it's okay. We're going to watch these behind the scenes videos that we missed last time.
Okay.
And then we will move on to a new PlayStation 2 demo disc.
Okay.
How's that sound?
That sounds
fabulous.
I want to adhere to the rules.
Yes. So if people saw the last one, we did not see that there was a behind the scenes thing, and so we're going to make good on it. And watch this video of
back with the Lucas team.
yeah. Start your freaking behind the scenes this spring, the sequel to Jedi Starfighter video game for the PlayStation 2 video with that iconic text treatment.
We got to establish, you know, when and where Star Wars takes place.
Establish that haircut.
The original Starfighter. With episode 2, the game starts 10 years after the original Starfighter ended.
I did not play this game.
Except with a character that was in Starfighter, Nim.
That classic character.
Who was in episode 1, Addy Gallia.
According to his personality profile. Uh-huh.
He's the heroes of episode 7, right?
Yep.
Yeah. She's a strong woman. She was part of the Jedi Council in episode 1. You would have seen her in the
movie. Oh, LucasArts.
She drives a cool vehicle.
You miss him?
And she's pretty fierce.
Yeah. Pretty cool vehicle. She drives.
And of course they meet, and Nim's kind of the Han Solo, skeptical of the
I didn't know
Jedi
pirates
religion,
worked on
that
this
stuff.
Game.
Jedi? Ready, are you insane?
I'm here now, you might as well let me help.
Fine, but no lectures and no Jedi mind tricks.
And so he and Addy don't get along very well to begin with, and of course just like
what year is this?
Luke and Han, they establish a friendship and Nim realizes
still like,
valuable.
Did we determine it was 03 or something?
He's unpredictable
somewhere around there.
She is by the book.
So still the
90s. Well together.
What?
03, no.
Yeah.
Oh, you gotta be kidding.
03 was in the 2000s.
Although Nim is skeptical initially,
still the
90s.
He starts
to believe in the Force when he sees how powerful it is.
You know how years work?
Master Jedi.
We have four Force powers
decades.
Total, and we dole them out through the game.
Was this still the Factor 5 or Level 5? I always get those mixed up.
Factor 5 was,
We be making our own Star Wars.
Because if you see a bunch of ships flying together, you can jam it properly and take out all of them at the same time.
It's like the lamest
awesome.
Pirate
Another
in the world.
Another fun one is shield. It acts like a normal shield, but if you get what's called a force clarity, the shield will not only reflect.
I feel bad. I'm sure that Mr. Longo is a very nice man.
The third power is force reflex.
Yeah.
The entire game world, but the Jedi stays.
At first, I thought it was like an IFD or something in his ear, but so that does look like a pirate.
Locking onto the targets, we are.
Jedi had enhanced reflexes.
I thought it said Sabbath fighter at first.
Force shockwave. And that simply emits a large destructive force from the player in the kind of
nothing about that guy screams that he would have that ear.
Major amounts of damage.
The way he's dressed or the way he looks is at odds with that ear.
Because of the complexity of the Star Wars universe, the game developers at LucasArts have a very
Coast
close relationship
I guess
with
that
the creative team at Lucasfilm.
Because we're making a game, we need to get access to all of this stuff and shots of scenes and characters.
Gotta get these
They're
chairs
really
just right.
They do have more involvement than one would expect. They review all of our game designs.
Lucas was around here,
anything
right?
Goes into
yep.
our game. They do take.
They
a
were
look
up in Marin County for
even down
a
to
long
making
time.
Sure that okay. the lightsabers are the
close
right
to
color
the ranch,
the right
but not on the ranch necessarily. And then
at the same time,
in the Marin Technology
George
Center,
understands.
And then they moved
really
into
well
Presidio,
making
and now they've moved out of
movies. And he understands
they
that
don't
we need to
make
take
games
these
anymore.
Characters and
they
the
situations
to Disney. And
is the ranch like farther than where
way.
You live or do
no,
you go
I,
past
I
it?
I passed the exit that I would take to get to the ranch.
Really?
The story of the Star Wars
I had a friend who worked in the cafeteria there for a while.
Series.
I had a friend
we
who was on
their
private firefighting
in that
force
direction as well.
Whoa.
I had invites to go out there but never actually went.
The design for the Jedi Starfighter is that it is already going toward classic Star Wars. You have the cross between an A-Wing and a Star Destroyer. Basically, it looks like a mini Star Destroyer.
It's a triangle.
Yep.
But the lines
typing
are starting B-roll. To blur classic Star Wars and the prequel.
There was a button
sure.
on that interface that just said boom. That.
Yeah, I like that.
One of the new features of Jedi Starfighter is a two-player mode that can be accessed in every mission.
In Starfighter 1, we actually had some hidden two-player modes that you could unlock. With Jedi Starfighter, every single mission.
I'm pointing at the TV. See? He's shooting.
In single player mode or in two player mode.
You're right, he is.
We wanted to go crazy.
That's me,
that.
I'm
we
shooting.
To go as far as we possibly could. And a lot of us are
I feel like they used that shot before.
kind of sitting on the couch with your buddy and handing the controller over, and you're both in the same mission, and you're both calling
that's
out
how
orders to each
works.
Other. You know, come get that, you know, blow that up.
That.
You could play the
that's
first
going
I don't know about this game.
Missions in two-player mode, and then your friend goes home, and you want to keep playing, you just keep playing right on through the game in single-player mode and switch back as often as you want.
Beyond the new two-player mode, there's a ton of new bonus levels and materials in the game that should keep fans busy for a long time.
We have 10 bonus levels. We have 11 bonus movies.
What stands out to you guys is the best co-op you've played? I feel like I know what Drew's going to say.
Jango Fett.
Co-op.
We have team commentary video.
My initial designs were to have you.
I mean, Halo.
Yep, that's what they were going to say.
But that's just like another guy with you playing Halo.
But I mean, that's super fun. I mean, that's what co-op is a lot of the time.
Yeah,
it's just another dude there.
Gears of War, though, was really.
They did a good job.
They're really good.
Yeah.
Concept art, all kinds of good stuff.
Buddy's having fun.
Those were all the leads.
One that I really, really liked that people don't talk about enough is Mortal Kombat Shaolin Monks. I thought that was super duper fun. Je ne sais quoi.
As you play the game, if you're getting the bonus objectives and you're kicking ass, then you unlock all the
Star Wars people can't speak French.
So look for the things
that makes sense.
Space French in Star Wars.
Feel like you did it really well, like to eliminate all the
They speak English. Why wouldn't they also know French and Spanish and stuff?
It's called basic. Thank you.
What? Who calls it that?
Star Wars fans are some of the most hardcore fans in the world.
Hardcore Star Wars
interest
fans.
Has
really?
An impact on the LucasArts team.
No,
like the language
when
is
you
called.
Design a game with so many hardcore fans out there, you know that you're.
But French is an Earth construct.
Keep things consistent.
Well, so is English. We wouldn't, by coincidence, speak the same language
would,
as space people.
You could assume that if you're watching this, it's like watching The Hunt for Red October when they speak English
so
and Russian.
They're not really saying English words, but so us Earthlings could understand it.
Exactly.
They had, filter it. Okay.
Right.
Gotcha.
Although I think one of the characters in Star Wars speaks Portuguese.
Really?
Yeah.
That is not Sam Jackson's voice.
Whoa!
Just remember that it's my system. I call the shots.
Of course.
Great banter in this game.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Star Trek Next Generation ending of them warping out, hitting warp 9.
All right, there's that one. We'll see. Oh, Medal of Honor. So would this have been Frontline? I feel like this would have been around Frontline, right?
I think so.
I remember being excited
about
playing
this D-Day.
This
looks
like
an N64 game because the footage is so fucking blurry.
Yeah.
Spielberg charted a new course
for I wanted to play Allied Assault so bad because the D-Day stuff looked awesome. Mm. But I could never get it to run, so I was super excited about this. And it was actually pretty good, I remember.
Medal of Honor, and he was like, I'm working on this movie called Private Ryan. And I've been playing GoldenEye a lot.
Crisscross!
So, you know, why don't you guys do World War II GoldenEye? And, you know, it started from there.
Why is he wearing his shirt
that was
forwards?
The beginning of the wildly successful game called Medal of Honor. Since then, the team has produced 3 games in the series. Now,
dude, I never liked Medal of Honor.
No? They finished the I liked
it. It was another one of those things where, like, if you had a PC. Well, I mean, eventually they were coming to PC, but, like people that were playing them on the PlayStation go like, this is amazing. I'm like, no.
I mean, but to a certain audience, I was one
totally.
Of them
yep.
who did
yeah,
not
yeah,
play
yeah.
PC games.
Yeah.
It was awesome. That's why I love GoldenEye. That's why I liked Medal of Honor a lot. Because I didn't have Counter-Strike or Quake or any of that stuff.
Call of Duty, when it came out, though, was, to me, very impressive.
Oh, yeah.
One of the keys to the success of the Medal of Honor series has been its amazing realism. That even applies to
the
storyline.
Look at those fucking barrels.
Amazing piece of machinery.
Those are real World War II barrels, real swastikas, all that shit.
A weapon that shipped them in.
Tide of the war. And it's basically a flying wing. It looks like a stealth bomber. You'd be surprised at some of the technology that came out of World War II that just seems so far-fetched.
While our
that dude looks really familiar.
Is fictitious.
Yeah.
It actually was captured at the end of the war and is now seeing restoration so that it can be included in the Smithsonian exhibit. In addition to the Ho 9, every detail in Medal of Honor Frontline is meticulously researched.
From
books. Stole these books.
I think that people definitely get a feel for what it was like to fight in those locations. We do an extensive amount of research, both here on site through video and book, and normal research means
through
God, love
book.
The internet. We just went through the internet and just kept typing.
We downloaded the whole thing.
Things we were looking
all
for,
the internet.
there's a lot every of enthusiasts
probably possible
out there who collect
too.
Authentic yeah. items, and they'd have these.
There was a lot of weird porn, but also some World War II stuff. Those were the only two things allowed on the internet back then.
That's what it should look like when it's not new, but weathered and worn. We wanted to give them a little bit of like grit to them.
Watching movies, we get ideas, like the whole Nijmegen Bridge scenario is loosely based off of some stuff from A Bridge Too Far.
There's a team of climbers who are rogues who go around and illegally climb structures and take pictures of it during their escapades.
So isn't that
the pictures
crazy?
That he took while he was doing this were really important to me because they're from the undercarriage of the bridge where no pictures are of any of the detail under there. And a lot of the gameplay in this level takes place underneath the bridge, so I needed really good reference.
I remember this mission.
Jimmy is dropped into Holland with two other comrades. That whole environment in the Dutch pasture is based on a trip that my
this was super impressive back then. I remember.
Holland. And he visited a number of museums and took over 1,200 photographs.
I remember there was someone on staff at the time that was just like blown away by Medal of Honor. And I just remember looking at it and going, like, what are you even doing?
I mean, what were you playing at the time that was...
I can't remember exactly what, but it was, you know, like stuff on the PC. So,
that's a really interesting building.
You know, the PC games of the mid-90s.
Yeah.
But this is on my idea.
Mid to late 90s, I guess.
Another way the Medal of Honor team immerses you in the game is by working
hard. I guess this is
PS2
era, right?
So
this
look.
Is... Yeah, this is 02, 03.
In frontline, like those first PS1 games, I remember just
over 300 different.
Yeah, that was just Medal of Honor and then Underground. I remember it was like 98, 99.
Every time you see
in Underground, you can customize the cars and lower them and put neons on them and stuff.
From
it was cool.
The other enemies you will see. We've got certain technology that we're using where we will swap meshes between characters and heads between characters, and the textures will be different, and the characters will be different in terms of what they're wearing and what they're. Pack is in terms of what equipment they're carrying and so on and so
novel.
Forth.
Novel.
We've got guys in boxer shorts running around.
What?
We've got guys in bathrobes.
It was the style of the day.
Jacket. And then we tried to see how many ways we can combine the various pieces.
All right.
And come up
bathrobe
with
top,
pieces
no
top
underwear.
So
just the bottom bathrobe hovering there. And then the top half is Hitler. I don't know.
Medal of Honor is weird because you could unlock. Since Spielberg was like an executive producer, technically,
yeah.
They put in like a Velociraptor. So you could play as a Velociraptor in a World War II multiplayer game.
It's pretty great.
And I think Shakespeare was another one.
And he sculpted these heads.
Yeah, you could be Shakespeare and a Velociraptor.
Okay. Because Steven Spielberg.
Of course. Right.
And
of course.
Light it and then photograph it and use that as the base. And then from there, once it's mapped on and he's satisfied with the way it works on the three-dimensional mesh, he would go through it and start doing painting on top of it. He would paint in details and things like that.
There we go.
A little bit more realism. We actually would photograph various people around the building, use that for some of the variations in the textures. You know, it's funny. I keep thinking that I'm seeing various
cut
people
to some
around
programmer
the building in the game.
Exactly like Hitler.
I think our lead sound guy
wearing a polo
is
shirt.
The game. Our
yeah.
Backwards hat.
I think is in the game at certain places and. Sometimes, you know, if you're having
stuff like that, like shooting off helmets and stuff, was just fucking crazy when Medal of Honor first came around for console guys.
Yeah,
like you'd throw a grenade and one of the guys would take off his helmet and like jump on it to protect his buddies. Mm-hmm. Like, that stuff blew my mind back then. Nazi chefs.
Some of the enemies varied, but some of them actually changed throughout the game.
There's a chef or a cook that shows up in about four levels. He's just cool because he looks mean, and we put him through his paces.
He's pretty cool.
The game,
he's just cool.
Play,
Clive Barker's undying.
Each time you see him, there's a little bit more damage on him, wear and tear on his costuming, just because we thought, hey, you know, we don't have to reuse the assets from the first time we see him. We can actually give him a torn shirt. We can put a burn flash on his apron. We can give him a black eye. We can do all
these
things.
Power of the PlayStation 2. The emotion engine.
Emotion, yeah.
Unlike many current games, there's no motion capture used in the Medal of Honor series.
We made a decision not to use motion capture again in the very first game.
Don't look behind you.
Our
Sunil, don't look behind tradition.
You.
We key animate everything. We hand animate everything. And it's something we take a lot of pride in as well. We do a lot of acting out things. We are constantly seen running around in the hallways with video cameras
weightlifting
and
bench.
With weapons.
I mean, just imagine if you guys were like on a motion capture set, you could have mocap this whole thing and save some time.
All
right.
And all that. In fact, we tried to.
What are you doing?
But somehow they wouldn't let us have it. I still don't understand why. And the reason is we get into the skin of the characters. All the animators do that.
yeah, why would you use mocap?
One thing that I pride myself about the way animations are done for Medal of Honor is we use what's called a state-based system of animation. And the whole point is that we animate not just looping animations, but we animate entire mental states. And the cool thing is that you'll see different performances by the same character when played different times. So it's always organic. We don't have the same loop action.
Really.
Because that's one of the things
not
that
at all
totally
blown
kills
out.
Animation in games.
He's still pointing at you.
Perhaps the area where the animation can be seen most is the pub scene.
In Frontline, there's a scene where you infiltrate a Nazi pub, and there are about 20 Nazis in there. And there's about four or five guys playing cards at the table. There's a couple guys at the bar. There's a couple guards back at the door.
Tarantino totally ripped off Medal of Honor Frontline.
Yeah. To the side, and then there's a piano player. You can't get past the guards at the stairs until you do a little something. To
very dramatic.
The piano guy to play a little tune.
He's
and you
German.
Get all the guys singing. And then you can head off to the back of the pub, where there's another distraction you cause back there. But you're all weaponless at this point. And so it's a little bit of a puzzle.
We're
going
to rock 'em, sock 'em shit.
In your race to capture the Ho Nine, you find that you have an enemy who stands above the rest.
We're introducing a character named Albrecht von Sturmgeist, and he is the big
Ed
baddie
Harris.
Of the game. And he's the man in charge of
German
the
name
production.
Randomizer.
Yeah.
And so
right.
One of the first things Jimmy is told to do is to track this guy down. And we want him to be a compelling character who's pretty bad and eludes you pretty much till the end of the game.
Who's in your badass war game? Who do you
feel
play
like
as?
Equal and not like
Jimmy.
He's so hard that he'll take a bazooka shot to the head. And
what's the coolest
really
Jimmy?
That idea that he's more crafty than he is just.
Yeah, Jimmy Carter seems like a nice guy.
Dean,
super badass.
Jimmy Dean.
Yep.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that.
Sausage guy.
You're definitely
yeah.
gonna have
yeah, I like sausage.
Your brains and your arsenal. If you're gonna help Jimmy Patterson steal the Ho Nine in
Jimmy Hart
Frontline.
Yeah, yeah, Jimmy Hart.
Carter.
Hendrix. Page.
Oh, Hendrix! Oh, yeah, Hendrix and Pitt. Jesus Christ, yeah.
Jimmy Johns.
Jimmy Stewart. Jimmy Johns. All right.
Mm-hmm.
There's Frontline.
Great.
I don't know if there's more. I want to say it might have just been those two. Cool, oh, we got cool moves? Okay, how do we do? We go back. Last? Next? Why is...
Okay. I think we're still transitioning. Menus.
Oh,
here.
That's right. It does that stupid stuff. Download station. Cool moves.
Oh, yeah.
What?
We got to go through the ocean before we can get to the moves.
All right. How many moves can they fit on this disc?
We'll see. Well, if you want to beat Bone Grinder and Drakon the Ancient's Gates, let's see how we. Oh, is it a video?
Hi, my name is Saul.
Oh, yeah, please.
Today I'm going to show you a cool move for the game Drakon the Ancient's Gates.
In Tip Rider.
Cool move, I'm going to show you how to defeat the boss Bone Grinder in the Adrelian Isles. Let me show you how it's done.
Spoilers.
Before you enter the chamber with Bone Grinder, it's always good to power up with a spell. I chose the lightning spell.
Pretty crisp capture.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Once you enter the chamber, you're going to view a small little sequence.
This totally looks like early PS2, like, what was it, Summoner, like that type of stuff.
Yeah, so it's not that early, really.
I guess PS, that was October 2000 was PS2?
Yeah,
and this is 0203, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
Had a good run, though. PS3 wasn't until 06, right?
And use your spells
right.
On.
This is, like, right in the mid.
Oh, yeah, 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 totally, yeah.
Continue on to the next one.
These are pretty cool moves.
I had to beat this game as part of my job. The least I can do is tell you how to get past it
now
a little bit faster.
All the crystals have been destroyed. You can now attack Bone Grinder. Here I'm going to pick up my sword.
Good idea.
Whoa. Try using combo
I like how
attacks.
We can actually hear him hitting the buttons.
And target onto him.
Yeah.
It's immersive.
Like I'm
if your
really
sword
there.
Has any magic yeah. abilities.
Imagine this with Oculus.
Watching a quick work or something.
So much for your storm trap, Bone Grinder.
Good one.
Wow.
Yeah.
Burn.
That looked like a really hard fight, so I'm glad we had the tip rider.
And you can exit the area.
Well, I mean, you could beat it normally, or you could beat it with cool moves. So you decide how you want to be seen, you know?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I mean, he did it cool.
That was pretty cool.
Pull the switch to activate the teleporter. And exit the dungeon.
Thanks, Saul.
And as you can see, Aeroch is already here waiting for you.
Oh, that Aeroch.
Now take the game out of your PlayStation and never play it again.
And that's how it's done.
All right. I want to get a hard-to-reach power cell in the volcanic crater.
Hi, my name is Saul Villegas. And today I'm going to show you a cool move for the game Jack and Daxter. In this cool move, I'm going to show you how to get a hard-to-reach power cell in the level volcanic crater.
Hella
Let me show
decks.
You how it's done.
Yeah. Look at those things.
In order to get to this hard-to-reach power cell, you're going to have to head back into the level spider caves.
Sorry about that.
I should have told you earlier.
Down these pillars right here. And work your way into the level spider caves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What we're looking for right now is a yellow eco vent.
Is this the first Jack? Or is Jack 2?
It looks like Jack 1.
Use a trampoline right here.
I think I remember this level.
I was the ratchet guy.
A moving platform.
Not the Jack guy. I feel like you had to choose.
I was stupid for most of college because I thought, like, I would see my sister playing these games, and I would think, like, I'm too old for this type of stuff now or whatever. And so I didn't play Jack or Ratchet for the longest time. Until I remember the third Ratchet came out, and IGN gave it, like, a 9.8. I was like, holy shit, maybe these are actually, like, really good games. And I got them, and it turns out they are great, great games, and it's stupid to act like I was too old for these or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're fantastic games. I went back to all those, the HD collections of Sly and Jack and Ratchet. Oh, yeah. Love them all.
I just never had any interest in Jack.
Ratchet's much better. Like, the leveling up the weapons and stuff in Ratchet is way more fun than anything in Jack, but I did like these two.
I remember people were really big on Jack 2 with being kind of the open world thing.
As you can see, once you fire the
I don't know if I ever... That was the one where they introduced the, like, Dark Jack,
power
right?
Will be
sure,
down.
Probably.
Weird power or whatever.
I don't know. I never really played any of them.
There we go.
Daxter.
As you can see, it can be done. It's not easy. Practice makes perfect. If you're unable to do it the first time, just keep trying. Eventually, you'll get it.
No part of that looked like that. Just seemed like a matter of you knowing where it was. I don't know that seemed.
Oh shit!
All right, yeah. How do you unlock the secret level in Tokyo?
Hi, my name is Jay. I'm a quality assurance analyst here at Sony Computer Entertainment America.
A cool name.
I'm
Jay
here
Vo.
To do a cool move on the game Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3.
Jay Vo.
Doing this move, I'm going to show you how to access the secret level in the level Tokyo.
Oh, this fucking game is so good.
It's
once you take off from the level,
it's a really
position,
good game.
It's
I love this level too.
Box.
Look at how round those surfaces are.
Yeah.
Which leads to
power
the
PlayStation.
To the billboard sign, to the controller marquee, to the round blue neon sign. You gotta start
here. You're never soft
here.
Character.
Find the wire, jump in the marquee, jump, grind. And once you hit the two wires that hold the circle neon sign.
The one
sign,
that had Ace of Spades as the opening song.
So once you knock down the circle blue neon sign, you wanna jump inward on the second
actually, wrestling and Tony Hawk
in there, you
to Motorhead.
Access the ramp that goes to the secret level.
I mean, it's a hidden part of the level. It's not a secret level,
now you
Jay.
I know exactly where the secret area is. I hope
secret area, there you go.
Yeah, he knows what he's talking about.
Yeah, they said, Jay, just hype it up, man. Come on. We want people to watch this stuff.
Score hot points.
Is this just going to be go around the loop with baggage claim? Is this going to be run the loop with baggage claim? Steve Lewis, kick to me straight.
And I'm going to show you guys a cool move for Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3.
It better be the baggage claim thing.
I'm going to show you guys a really great spot to score a lot of points and a shortcut to get there.
Didn't they have to cut something? Like, they're originally a part of this level where they had terrorists come into the airport.
I don't remember.
And they had to cut it out because of 9/11, I think.
Yeah,
I want to say that.
Yes, that is exactly what he's doing. He's going through here.
Claim area.
Yeah, you got to jump up there. don't cut that out. That's the good stuff.
Once you get to the baggage claim area, you want to follow. You want to get onto these rails, which will take you into a.
There you go.
A U.
Also, he has perfect balance cheat turned on. By the way.
Oh yeah, he does, doesn't he?
Doing special tricks.
Come on.
Special rail
come on, Steve.
Maybe he's just really good.
What the fuck, Steve?
No one's that good at balance.
Steve
what
the fuck?
If I happen to accidentally fall off a rail. I just
Javo wouldn't have cheated.
Nope. Until I get back to the rail and hop back on and just continue this until I either A, think I'm going to crash or score
which
enough
is
points and
like never because this cheat. Word.
Hey,
click.
It is. That's how you score over 2 million points in Tony Hawk Pro
over
Skater
2
3 in one
points.
Run.
By cheating. Oh my goodness. Manual tricks doing the pogo thing over and over.
Everyone was good at Tony Hawk 3 in the QA department because they play real games down there.
Score massive amounts
really cold, too.
It can't be that cold in that room.
In order to do this trick,
If all the games that Sony published that year had some bugs in them, it's because everyone was just playing Tony Hawk 3. Yeah, wait, what? Easy manual tricks, just turn on perfect manual.
Triangle, square.
Who's got the better name between J-Vo and Bryn Berliner?
Square flips
the
board.
Good, I don't know.
J-Vo, you can spell with three letters.
That's true. It's two syllables, the whole thing. Yeah, I did this shit all the time.
Yeah.
Circle to do a handstand.
Without cheating.
Flip it over.
Do the pogo.
On track, push it again. Circle, triangle, square. I continue to spin. Push those three buttons.
Every fucking time.
This whole tip is mash buttons for points. Like just because I've picked
all my special tricks. A consecutive time. Square, square, triangle, triangles.
Yeah.
Can you do like? I can do the more advanced ones, like triangle, circle, or whatever. The pogo.
Incredibly large score.
I can't see footage of these old Tony Hawks without immediately wanting to play them.
Yep.
Let's do another handstand.
Still looks pretty good.
Yeah, and they play good.
Do this, you never want to hit X because you'll jump out of the trick. Now you'll notice that my multiplier is going up every time I flip the board or kick it around.
Just keep pressing buttons until you die.
If I want.
Just life advice.
Yep.
When you're finally ready to get out of it, you just hit X and land the trick.
You told me never to hit X.
It's gonna be too many points.
And
that's
sick,
my cool
right?
move. My tribute to Rodney Mullen. If you notice, there's a video in there where he does the same kind of tricks. I hope you can get a big score like that, too.
Da-da-da.
All right, I think we were done with this one.
Okay.
All right, we've done our duty. Drew, why don't you toss in, what is this, 85?
Yep, issue 85.
All right, we're going to go forward. There's 12 months a year. I'm going to say that's 2.5 years or so.
Okay.
Some quick math, maybe. I see Ludacris on the front of this disc.
Oh boy.
That's usually a good sign.
You're going to need to reset this thing.
You're going
to
need to reset
this
thing.
We'll do it this way. All right.
Reboot!
So, I went through the strenuous task of hitting X on those. So, I will hand this to my left, give Jeff the dual shock here. And we'll start with the games, as we usually do. I looked
Turn
at the
it
list.
Off. Perfect. Manual balance for that thing. Come on.
Yeah.
What kind of QA tester are you?
It's not how you play that game. Have you known a lot of people that did QA?
Not a ton.
It doesn't sound fun.
It's a great
summer job.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, great summer job.
I could see that. But I know a lot of people
Alex did it for a while.
I know a lot of people that do it because as like an in to the industry, either in journalism or development. And I don't know if it's, I haven't heard that many stories of that happening. Occasionally.
Yeah, because a lot of them are contract jobs that at the end of the contract they go like, all right, later. Like, yeah. It sounds relatively thankless.
I think I've heard of Epic. I think Epic has done a decent job of like bringing up QA people to like actual full-time positions, but I think that's an
exception.
Certainly
it certainly does happen.
You've really got to distinguish yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did not play this game. Is this going to be a montage of every game that's on this disc?
No, it's probably just a forced ad for this thing.
Okay.
So is this like a SOE put this out? Is this like a Champions of Norrath like?
I do not know.
Sequel? I'm trying to remember.
Looks kind of Baldur's Gate, Dark Alliance-y.
Yeah, yeah, that was all kind of the same type of stuff.
I loved that game.
Norrath was good too. The Snowblind that did those, right?
Sounds about right. Online, eh? Oh, okay. Pushing into that era.
Yeah.
The only things I played online on PS2 were Ratchet and Clank 3 and Twisted Metal Black, that extra, like, online edition they put out with the broadband adapter or whatever.
Oh,
if I'm remembering right.
I played a whole lot of Tony Hawk 3.
Oh, yeah.
I played a whole lot of SOCOM. And SOCOM 2.
Boy, I did not like SOCOM.
I had a roommate who was way into SOCOM, and we both, you know, got into it. It was one of those weird cases where, like, like I probably shouldn't have... Well, this is great already.
We'll get there. We got to play first.
Okay. We don't want to go inside the... Yeah, I don't want to go inside anything.
Oh, can't wait to watch
PlayStation Underground at E3. That'll be good.
I think we should just go in order. Start with inside the game.
Well, in Playground, where you did it default to inside the game?
Yeah, defaulted. It was
well.
Here.
I mean, if that's where they want us to go.
Yeah.
All right.
Let's jump in. Oh my God! Yes. Amazing.
Are you ready to go inside Playboy the Mansion?
I've been ready forever. Let's do it. Jesus. Rating pending. I wonder what that's going to get. I never played this.
This is the world-famous Playboy Mansion, replete with exotic creatures of all shapes and
sizes. Remember, there was a trend there where during E3, someone would hold a party at the Playboy Mansion.
Really?
I remember hearing about that.
I remember I got invited to one for, there was a publication launching. Like a new site or something, and they had their party there. It was one of those things where people were like, oh, they must have a lot of money. And then I got uninvited from the party like the week before.
You did?
E3. They're like, I mean, the list is getting pretty full, so. And I was just like, I'm definitely not going because I'm too busy working at E3, so fine. Like, no hard feelings. I don't really care, but.
Would that have been like an Insight magazine launch or something?
No, it was a website, I think.
Oh, okay. Cyber Lore Studios. Or like a new, different
style mansion. It's up to you. And they must have had done a party for there for this game, right?
I mean, I think that's what this is.
Yeah.
Braz Brock? Is that somebody's name?
Oh boy.
Braz Brock. The bummer.
It was a real bad Sims-ish thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Man show set. Your own path to fame and fortune. A lot of people's
main goal in life is to actually go to the Playboy Mansion. And for those sad individuals, we wanted to provide a virtual experience because they'll probably never get there.
Main goal in life. Interviews, articles. You put out your magazine, is this like 1969? Like, look at how black a hair Hugh Hefner had. The gameplay, the magazine is very much a core component
of the gameplay, which is it gives this not just a lifestyle sim, but a bit except of a business for sim as well, which you're kind of missing something there. To start having fun, you'll need someone to show you the ropes,
preferably a knowledgeable Playboy bunny. It's a blast. I'm such a game junkie. I do the tutorial to actually walk you through the Playboy Mansion game. So if you're playing the game and you're Hef, you have to talk to me.
You'll need to run a tight ship to keep your business growing. Land hotter celebrities for interviews and make more
money to keep you in the Playboy style to which you become accustomed. I mean, it's a good-looking young Hugh Hefner. Is about, first of all,
freedom. And it is what is that shirt?
Freedom. Freedom. Well, motherfucker.
Like Skyrim of Playboy games.
No, about like America. And no one embodies living the high life any better than Hugh Hefner. His input on the game was important in terms of style and philosophy. You're making a what? His character looks and moves and making sure that we got the pajamas exactly right, which is really cool. But also looking at the overall feel of the game to make sure that it's really getting across Playboy, because he is Playboy. His famous line is, my life is an open book with a lot of great pictures.
Now, there may be some who say they buy Playboy magazine for the articles, but we're guessing most people might want to see some photos of scantily clad, sexy Playboy bunnies.
I can't wait to see myself. I'm going to be in the game.
The player will be able to actually conduct photo shoots with Playmates. It's such a cool, unique.
Hey guys, I mean, one of the core parts about these photos in this magazine you're talking about is that they're nude photos.
Of actual ladies. Not this right, PlayStation 2 era. Like, it's really addictive, Jesus. And it's
kind of like a mini game in a sense. Great features and different modes of play. Simulation and empire building games will
never be viewed in quite the same light. Other sim titles basically emulate mundane lifestyle. This is a game actually lets you really live a fantasy world. And you get to play Hef, live in his mansion, have all the celebrity friends come over and throw wild parties.
Celebrity
and, you know,
friends.
That's above and beyond any other Sims game that I can think of.
I think people are going to be so fascinated with being able to reconstruct.
You'll have to kick Bill Maher out all the time. It'll be great.
Do anything that they want. Change our.
I bet they really
loved
it. He said Sims
color,
games.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And just have a lot of fun.
There has never been a game out that is
sure.
Like,
what is going on there?
The high life, the lifestyle, everything that Playboy has to offer, and doing
low frame rate video.
Sexy,
Playboy's
sexy
known
title.
For.
There has been nothing like it in the video game industry, and only Playboy can truly deliver on
how
that.
Is Playboy still a thing
in the
with the internet?
Mansion. Game.
What's their game plan? How are they making money?
Well, they're differentiated. They're not. If you think about what is on the internet, it's filth. Capital F, filth.
I think all five are capital letters.
Okay, yeah, sure. Yeah. And bold. Playboy is like several steps back from that. It's in a somewhat more respectable way that you might be able to say, oh, this is, there's art here.
It is classy.
That's not to say
by
that
comparison.
There is not art in smut. I can tell you with some authority that there is, but you know, they're classing it up a little bit. It's not, you know, you open up an issue of Hustler.
Yeah.
It's full penetration. It's Butthole City. There's all kinds of crazy stuff.
It's my favorite section of Hustler.
Yeah, no, and then
Butthole City, USA.
And then Penthouse was just straight up water sports all the time. Playboy.
Super Soaker Reviews, Drew. That's what they did. They review water guns and stuff, yeah.
Okay.
Playboy did not stoop that low.
What else is in here?
What? That's it.
Just that's all on the disc. This endless loop of Playboy the Mansion.
All right, well, let's move down to Replay.
What is that?
I guess.
Is that like a review of Fight Night?
I have no idea what any of these are.
Well, this is the cool moves section.
Find hidden icons. Okay.
Is that a tree from the living forest?
Rated C for teen.
Hi, I'm Jesse, and I'm going to show you how to unlock a couple of the old school levels in Tony Hawk 2. On the newest one, Tony
Gaming
Hawk
experience.
Is he being teleported?
One of the first places to find this hidden is in the northeast part of the Hawaii level.
He's back in time, and his parents aren't kissing.
Flaming tiki. Tiki stuff you get off your skateboard and jump right into his mouth. He'll end up in a lava tube. Now you run down to the end of here, and you'll see a little hanging icon that's the Tony Hawk 2 cover art.
Yeah.
It's a little tricky at first, but you jump through and you'll see
school with a K.
You unlocked a level, Venice, from Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. Another of the secret tapes is hidden in the Moscow level. Again, it's easiest if you jump off your board, walk over directly to the right from the start.
Visually, this all looks pretty much the same as that Tony Hawk 3 footage we just saw, but it doesn't activate that part of my brain the way the Tony Hawk 3 does.
Well, it's because he's off the board.
You'll see another one of those icons.
It's because he's
off the board.
Yeah.
What is this crap? Come on. Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. Finding these two tapes are going to unlock two levels from Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. There's one more tape.
You ever have a little lip goatee thing going on?
Soul patch?
Try and find it for yourself.
There was a very brief period of time where I had that.
Did you?
And mostly because I thought it was funny, and then it kind of got out of control. And
hi, I'm Jamie Kuroiwa. I'm a senior analyst at Format QA. And if you're like me,
who needs experience when you have 100% pure skill like me?
Your character. I'll show you a little
trick
to shorten that time in half. Okay, when you're sufficiently beat down like Samunosuke here, normally you'd have to stand still and wait for Akko to start to heal your character.
Yeah.
As you can see, that healing bar moves really slow. So the trick is to rotate the right analog stick on your controller in a circular motion.
We really need
and
to
if you rotate it faster, she'll heal you even faster.
Nice. I never got to know anyone.
So there you have it.
Yep.
An efficient way to sabotage Old Man Time's plans. It'll take a little skill, but I have faith in you.
Skill to rotate a stick.
Wow, I think from that, I know I never want to play anything in that series ever.
Well, you just don't have the skill.
Oh, this is a download.
Oh,
with everything unlocked in Fight Night 04.
Oh, wow.
Except the entrance place.
Yeah, of course. You guys ready to take it to the playground?
Yeah, let's do it. Fight Night 04. I thought it was just Fight Night.
All right, here are our demos.
I'm seeing
something there.
I think we'll save that for Mr. Scantlin.
Oh, boy.
I think it's just a video.
So should I play Star Wars?
You know, we have done this before on Demo Derby. Remember? We did this on Xbox One.
Yeah, that was Battlefront 2, I think.
Okay. If you want to dink around for a second, and then we can back out early. I mean, we've seen Battlefront on here before.
Call him up.
I want to.
Hey, what's T mean?
771-3772?
Video tames.
I'll call him.
Which video games are right for me?
Sorry, you have dialed a number which cannot be reached when
you're
calling
her. The SRB shut down.
There's no law anymore.
It's Mad Max now. I feel like Endor was the thing you did. This looks a lot like what you did on that Xbox One.
I mean, it's still Star Wars.
Dark Stormtrooper.
This doesn't look as muddy as the Xbox one we did.
Defend the shield bunker.
It does have kind of a bloom effect on it.
Yeah. Yeah, this looks identical to what you did on the Xbox demo derby.
I don't remember that. Was I not there for that?
No, that was just me and Jeff.
Okay.
We're depleting the rebel reinforcements.
You're a big Star Wars guy?
Yep.
Yeah?
Yep.
It's good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta be excited for those new ones, right?
Yeah.
Me too.
Not the greatest woodland camouflage, the bright orange.
Nah, neither is the bright white. I guess, yeah, isn't bright orange what hunters wear when they're in the woods so other hunters will see them, obviously?
Yeah,
yep. Rebels want to make sure they're safe, they wear safety orange. It's
gonna shoot each other.
What do we got over here?
Tinga, tinga, wanga!
It's a stormtrooper.
We've captured a command post.
Okay.
Yeah, this looks like Battlefront.
Yep.
Yeah, and change weapons and,
yes, sir.
And shoot.
Yes, sir. Is this online?
I think so. I mean,
I believe it was. And it's just a series that I never really jumped into. Now, with PS2, you never had to pay any kind of monthly fee, right? You just bought the broadband thing and you just played, yeah.
Enemy forces have
at the time, Xbox Live did cost money.
It did,
right?
Yeah.
But that did have the built-in thing, so you didn't have to buy equipment.
Right.
Yeah. All right, Battlefront.
You've seen the movies. Now live them.
Hey, there you go. All right, I'll take the next one, whatever that may be.
Coming in September 2004.
Oh, pandemic. I didn't know they were.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
You ever played The Saboteur?
Yeah.
What do you think of that?
I didn't much care for it. It had heart. It was well made in a lot of ways, but it didn't really. I don't know.
I wanted to like it more than I did since I loved Mercenaries so much.
Yeah, there was some cool stuff in there. But.
Tell everyone that you know more than they do.
Yeah, become their best friend. That's how you do it. You motherfuckers don't know shit. I know everything.
I will play Demon, whatever that font says. Stone?
Stone?
L2 team attack. Target lock. Killing blow. Special action / jump. Super attack. Secondary attack. Timer. Parry.
Looks like you can control multiple characters.
Oh boy, okay. Drew, you lucked out. You get Ace Combat 5.
Great.
It's like just the Lost Vikings.
Here it is again.
Oh, it's a D&D game.
Oh.
From Atari. Infograms. Ograw. I don't know
how to speak French. I think that's how you pronounce it.
Wizards of the Coast, are they the parent company of D&D?
Yeah.
Yes, they bought all that stuff. They are the Magic the Gathering company that got so big that then they just swallowed up everything else.
Oh, so they're pretty big.
Yeah.
In the heart of the jungles,
figure they'd have to be if they're a tabletop thing.
Patrick Stewart is talking, please.
Infested with evil.
Is that really him?
To this place, I, Kelvin Blackstaff, have sent three heroes on a last desperate quest to retrieve a stolen gem of immense power.
A Chaos Emerald.
Oh no.
If they should fall, all of Faerun falls with them. That's it. The Demon Stone.
Let's grab it and get out of here.
I'll bring my dreadlocks.
He's raised a barrier. We're trapped.
Let's run into the barrier more. Uh-oh.
You gotta fight a lot of snake mans.
All right.
Hey, you're in it.
I'm just gonna hit killing blow a bunch. Nope, that's not. Nope. I guess I'm gonna have to do this stuff. Square is parry. Let's see if I can get the timing figured out here. Hey, fuck you. All right. I parried the shit out of that.
I don't remember anything about this.
I don't either.
I'm not even sure that this exists.
I mean, I'm looking at it on a TV right now.
I can't be certain. This seems like the sort of fake video game that my mind might just come up with by mistake. And then call it, I don't know, Demon Stone.
Jeff, wake up, your alarm's going off.
Just 10 more minutes, Mom. I don't want to go to school today. I'm very sick. Yeah, attack the bridges so they can't keep spawning in.
That actually looks pretty cool when you take out a bridge.
Oh, that guy's... Remember, you can push in the directions on the D-pad to change characters.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'll be this dude. Yeah, now we're talking.
That guy's got a stick.
Fuck yeah. Killing blow. Yeah! This combat just feels pretty muddy. Man, there was a lock on, wasn't there?
Some nice shadows.
Full name, Forgotten Realms Demon Stone.
Yep, no knowledge or memory of this whatsoever.
Storefront, R.A. Salvatore. Bob, to you and me, wrote on this. Came out in 04. PS2, Xbox, PC. Michael Clark Duncan does a voice. Drizzt Durden is in the game.
Oh.
He's a playable character at one point.
Mershok of the Eternal Hunger. He gains his strength from living sacrifice.
Yep.
Those creatures are his meal. Don't let him eat.
Oh, okay.
Go stop that snake man from sacrificing himself to the big guy.
Oh, is that guy going in there? I can't go up there.
Oh, okay. All right. I thought that...
The barrier!
He's just watching.
Uh-oh.
Okay, I guess we're just gonna go do that. Yep. All right. Yeah!
You shoot stuff at the one on the ramp.
I don't think it was gonna let me. What the hell? Is it one and done? I do like how the health meter has a picture of the snake guy's head on it.
Mm-hmm. Helpful.
Let's see who else I can control here. Is this idiot? Yeah. Oh. Okay, I want to be... Can I not be the girl? Oh, wait, I'm the girl now. It's all kicky. This isn't very fun.
It doesn't look.
Then you should stop playing.
I'm gonna stop playing it, and I'm gonna hand you this controller, Drew.
Okay.
There you go. That's Dungeons and Realms, Demon, whatever.
Yep. All right. Out this fall.
You're a D&D expert now, Dan.
I'm learning. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Have you cast any spells like Friends or Tensor's Floating Disc yet?
What?
Okay. Tell everyone you know more than they do.
Oh, Drew, it's a pretty good one.
All right.
Man, I love these games.
Ooh, pressure-sensitive yaw.
There you go.
Yaw.
I hope this is one of them that had it where if you hit circle to shoot a missile, if you hold it in, the camera follows the missile, which is just my favorite thing in the whole world, is when you can watch the missile go in and hit something.
All right. I wonder if this will have a bunch of the story stuff in it or if it'll just be drop you into shooting stuff.
They were pushing the story stuff pretty hard around this point, so... I bet they would put it in here.
Nimical.
Project Aces. They always had those weird project things with like Soul Calibur. Was it Project Soul?
Yeah, I think so. It was technically, you know, it was like their name for the team that was working on it. You know?
Yeah. The journey begins. It sure seems like Ace Combat 5. Starts
from the Metal Gear Solid of Ace Combat games.
I was literally just thinking that. I was absolutely... Yeah, what Metal Gear is to, like, action games, this is... Yeah. Wow.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know much about the Ace Combat series.
They started telling stories of, like, people that were not in the war. They were on the ground during the conflicts and stuff. And then, so it was like, Listen, this the only thing across that kind of civilian story intercut with you blowing shit up and vice versa. It's just.
Yuktobania just declared war. Not at first, though. I remember, like, the PS1
No, not
games
at first. I mean, originally it was an arcade game.
Yeah.
It was just like fucking. It might as well have been Afterburner.
And then Ace Combat 2 is pretty straightforward. I remember 3, that was Electrosphere, wasn't it?
Or
was
that 4? That sounds right.
I think they might have started introducing some story stuff then. Arne Anderson.
Putting doing brainbusters on these planes.
God, I'm a sucker for these. I actually didn't play Assault Horizon. Well, I did at E3, and it turned me off so bad that I didn't actually want to play the full game.
Yeah,
the shaky cam crap.
Yeah, it was terrible.
I really hated that.
I got motion sick.
Yeah, that game. Yeah.
I kind of lost interest in these types of dogfighty jet games after the first Ace Combat.
Really?
Like, it just sort of... It became really straightforward, and, you know, you'd end up with a lot of escort missions and stuff.
Yeah.
And just things that... First.
I'm just kind of a sucker for these. Like, if I can just fly around and watch missiles go into planes and, you know, do strafing runs on, like, ground targets and stuff, like, it's just great mindless fun for me. I don't, like, rank them among my favorite games ever, but I will always have fun playing these.
Yeah. Yeah, dogfighting is fun.
Yeah.
And this is one of those games where, like, they took, they put in some effort to make the jets realistic and got the licenses and did stuff, but like then it would get set against such nonsense that it was like...
Again, Metal Gear.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like super realistic weapons and stuff.
Right.
But then Metal Gear happens.
I guess, yeah, pretty much. In fact, I was sure of it.
This is dramatic.
It's the unsung war, Drew.
Hmm. Is this the last numbered Ace Combat game? Was there a 6?
There was one on 360 that had online.
Yeah, but I don't know if it had a number on it.
I want to say it said 6. Let's check on that. I don't remember a subtitle. I remember reviewing it back in like...
I saw the words three-dimensional shooting game in there.
Yeah.
Accurate.
It ain't lying.
Accurate.
Oh, man, I remember these menus. I love the SU-35. That was my favorite.
Ace Combat 6, Fires of Liberation.
Okay, but it did have the
switch,
right?
That was for the 360, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
All right, F-18 or F-14. I gotta go with the F-14.
Yeah, bigger numbers, better, right?
Okay, and then there's nothing... There has not been an Ace Combat 7. Assault Horizon is the game that you would consider AC-7, I suppose, but...
I've had that on my list of, like, backlog games for years, but, like, it's just one that I should just erase, because I just know I'm gonna not like it. Captain, which plane should I use?
Roger, roger. Ace Combat 0, the Belkan War...
I don't know if I played that. What
Ace
was that
Combat
on?
X, Skies of Deception.
I feel like I... Was that PSP? I think I played Ace Combat.
Was PSP.
Yep, I played that one. I reviewed that one.
Then AC-6. Then Ace Combat Xi. Set during the events of Ace Combat X, or XI. Lowercase I.
Huh. Drew, if I remember right, it's R1 to accelerate, and then once you get a lock, you can usually shoot like 2 missiles at once. I would always do tap hold on the circle. If you want to be a dork like me and watch the missile go in. I think once you get a little under 1,000, you should be able to get a lock. What? Oh, good. Did you hold it?
Yeah.
Damn it. Ace Combat Infinity came out for the PS3 last year.
Oh, really?
Oh, but that was that free-to-play one.
Okay. Huh. Maybe this demo didn't have the missile follow thing. Unload. Yeah.
Destroy.
You had tone.
I would just have fun trying to just fly straight up and see if it would let you go like into like sea space or whatever before you stalled out and went down and crashed.
Mm-hmm.
Just loved everything about these.
I played a lot of jet games and stuff as a kid. Just, you know, and obviously they didn't look anything like this. Well, I don't know. F-15 Strike Eagle for the Atari 800.
Looked just like this.
Didn't look unlike this.
We're liking the soundtracks of this. Like, yeah, this is bringing me back.
We're cool.
Some hot ground textures right there. Real high-res stuff.
So the SAAMs, I can't remember if those were against ground targets. 14 of those. I want to say triangle switch between your missile types.
I think triangle switches between targets.
Okay.
Attack?
Oh, that's telling your buddies what to do. Yeah. I can't remember how to, you can switch to those SAM missiles or whatever. I don't remember how. X should be your machine gun.
It is.
Maybe square switches? Bam!
I think a lot of cases, like, the game just kind of came down to this. It's like, line it up, get tone, fire the missile, move on to the next target. Like, it kind of got a little...
Yeah.
A little rote. The AI wasn't always great at just dogfighting you.
Yeah.
And then, honestly, when they did get really good at dogfighting you, that wasn't much fun either.
Yeah. It's just constantly trying to get them in your view.
It's, yeah, I mean, I would have thought I would have fallen in love with multiplayer dogfighting games. But it ends up being, you're just kind of just doing circles around each other forever.
Yeah, when I first heard
that,
and
none of you pass out because you were sitting in front of a television.
I remember when I heard that was six and I had Xbox Live and stuff. It's like, oh man, this sounds great. Like, this is the natural next evolution of stuff. And it just wasn't really that fun at all.
Yeah. Yeah, I got into, you know, what was it, like Blazing Angels? And like, there's a lot of flight stuff over the last chunk of time that...
Blazing Angels, Ubisoft?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That stuff was okay.
Is that the one that the 99 Nights guy did? Talk?
No, I don't think so.
He was behind one of those. I remember, like, it wasn't publicized that much, but I remember being at E3, and, like, he was the one that gave my demo, and I was like, oh, I didn't know you were working on this. Hmm. Triangle switch between targets? Like, I think, yeah, there you go. Good sound.
That gun is firing really quickly.
Yeah. Yeah, planes are cool.
Yep.
Planes are really cool.
Seems like we shouldn't have this technology yet. Fly through the air. Seems like that's something. Like that and LASIK surgery. I think those are two things that I feel like should be around in like 400 years. And yet we have them in now. It doesn't make any damn sense.
And air travel is the most like boring, like rote thing in the world. It's just like, I'm getting on this sky bus.
Yeah, people just
and unless
complain
you look
about
out the window,
time.
You would never even think like, oh, I'm in the air.
Yeah, you just go into this building for a while and then you arrive somewhere else.
I still find myself like, not every flight, but you know, depending on the weather and stuff, just endlessly staring at the ground the whole time, going like, it looks like The Sims or something down there.
Yep.
It's like Sim City out there.
God, I've just flown over Kansas so many goddamn times, and it's just squares.
Just looks like this.
No, this is exciting compared to Kansas.
Yeah, man, go below radar.
Oh dear.
That's a little bad. Like,
you're too young to be a smoking hole on the ground.
Control's nice.
Yeah, I like those. Takes flight. Fall 2004. All right, back over to Jeff here.
Okay.
Intense air combat action.
Dassault
A systems.
Oh, Boeing?
Before anyone else systems.
All right, Jeff, what do you got?
Tell everyone that you know more than they do.
Okay, this is weird, Jeff, this next one, because this came out right around the time that I was working at a Funko Land, or I guess GameStop at that point. I've never heard of this game. I at least heard of just about every game during this period.
Asterix is a French comic strip cartoon, whatever it is, from the guy that did the Smurfs.
Really?
Yeah.
Man, I don't
remember
this
coming
to the store.
It has been in video games a lot. The video games didn't always make it over to the U.S. and he's some kind of Viking guy. I don't know. French.
The development studio sounded very French. It's like Etoile Libiz.
Well, I mean, it's Atari, which
the most French
it was Info. I mean, at the time, it was Infogrames. It was literally quite French.
There it is.
Etranges Libellules.
Sacre bleu! What does that actually mean?
Like, holy
my goodness?
Shit.
Or?
I don't know. Making that up.
Sangre, blood,
blue
blood.
Blood,
blue blood.
Oh yeah,
I'm going with blue blood.
All right,
sacred something.
was Asterix and Obelix.
Obelix is like his sidekick.
Who's Buttrix?
That's just, I don't know. That's probably just like, you know, the funny way for them to talk about kicking butts.
Okay. That was Ratchet and Clank's gimmick. Up your arsenal and going commando.
Which I never understood, because, like, they don't seem like the kinds of games that would trade on double entendre.
I mean,
yeah,
they weren't, like, particularly...
Like
They weren't, like, risque, I mean.
Right.
Yeah. All right.
At least I think it was the Smurfs guy. I don't know.
See, a lot of accents over letters here. Oh, we get the restrictions on both of the characters.
Registered.
Oh, registered. That's right.
Gaw.
Drew, does this hold up history-wise?
Sure. Yep.
Okay.
Did you guys ever see that TV show? It only lasted, like, I don't even know if it lasted one season. It's called Kings. It was like modern day. It was like telling the story of ancient empires, but in like the future. It was not modern day. It was like near future.
I kind of remember like a marketing push for this.
Sounds like Too Human.
Yeah.
Cyber Valhalla.
But like the first episode is like this guy named David takes out a tank called a Goliath.
Oh wow.
So it was like weird like metaphors for stuff like that. It was bizarre.
Like Cleopatra 2525?
I don't know what that is.
Man. You don't know what Cleopatra 2525
is? No. What is it?
It was a syndicated television show.
Okay. What's going on here?
Whoa!
Dogmatics!
I'll never not laugh at DMX jokes.
Okay, Jeff, you can play now.
Okay, I'm using the analog stick. I'm
not controlling the camera.
Well, that's a hell of an art style. I mean, that looks pretty decent.
He compresses and elongates just like a cartoon.
Yeah. You're not strong enough to do that, Asterix.
Greetings. Please don't hit me. I have invaluable help to offer you.
Man, video games.
I used to be a spy and imagine me. I intend to.
How about Rome? You guys ever watch that? HBO?
No.
Oh, yeah. I like that a lot.
I trust that it's good if it's HBO.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
They don't really mess up. Except for what was that? John from Cincinnati? That's by the Deadwood guy, and it was supposed to suck, right?
Your friends need.
Deadwood was awesome.
I've never seen Deadwood.
Oh, it's so fucking good.
There's like something about the there we go. The pitch of the camera was really bugging me.
Bang, 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 bang. He's got a real interesting animation when he walks.
Several parts of this reminded me of Crash Bandicoot. The music and just kind of the animation and the boxes. Yeah. Yeah.
Seems like a very competent game.
Yeah. Know what that meter is?
Yeah, I don't know.
Filled a jar of milk, and now you're filling your pee jar. Oh, no, that's all milk.
When it reaches the top, you get a baguette. I don't know. And then a beret. And
get one more up near the president of France.
Yeah, okay.
France have prime ministers or presidents? President.
Sarkozy was the president of France.
Okay. Is the French president the one that's like a big skis and has like 9,000 mistresses and like doesn't even try to hide it? I know there's some notorious world leader. It might be Italy, I'm not sure. I want to say Berlusconi, but that might be a type of pasta.
Well done. I'll open up the path for you. Use this small platform to cross the fence.
What?
Don't forget to push.
Push the platform. It'll help.
To cross the
There's
fence.
Not a moment to lose, and they said, from what I understand, I should approach it. If you catch
it, seems like he's up to something.
The length of time between each line of dialogue is murderous to the pacing, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, that's how, you know, whatever. That's how games were. Some of them still kind of are.
Yeah. I was hoping that would happen a bunch more.
Yeah, me too. His range is really shitty, and there's no float. There's no Batman float from enemy to enemy.
Right.
Yeah, you gotta get right up on him.
So you kind of have to. You know, I can't just mash forever.
Any kind of lock on?
No, doesn't seem like it. I can hit the triggers and bring up all this stuff on the screen.
Cool.
Fill it full of HUD.
Almost filled your milk bottle. Jesus.
Way to go, Jeff.
I'm breaking this stuff.
You're good.
All right.
Tell your friends that you know more than they do.
Not just your friends.
Everyone. Tell everyone.
Everyone. Your teachers.
The only strategy, bash the Romans and save your friends. It's time to kick buttocks.
It's got vehicles? All right. Yep, there you go.
Everyone.
All people.
All right, oh, Spy Vixen. This was sweary, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a sweary joint.
Drew, to give you some context.
Please.
I remember some magazines trying to build this as like a Metal Gear Solid killer.
Okay.
And I got real excited. It is like a weirder in a different way Metal Gear Solid. It's like sweary weird, not Kojima weird.
Right, yeah.
But
which,
it's also
which sounds like it would be like an amazing game, but like the gameplay kind of wasn't there.
It's not great.
Forrest Kaysen.
Is he in this?
I believe
Access
so.
Games.
Awesome.
Yeah, I did not like this game.
Or at the very least, I believe there's a character named Forrest Kaysen.
Sure.
That's
easy. Sure.
Right. Billy Bishop!
I think I can only be Billy Bishop. Phantom Team Leader. Cannot use female disguises.
Yeah, Agent 2 can, though.
Oh.
Can't but pick her. Agent. Yeah, looks like.
Okay, yep. I do want to. Oh. Defaults to no? Okay.
Nah. Non-destructive menu.
All right. Crouch, cycle targets, first person, center camera, item. Menu.
That is something that a game tester would test for.
Is what?
Mm.
A non-destructive UI.
Oh, okay.
So basically, if you are just mashing A, nothing can, your menu's not supposed to default to something that can alter the like save state.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Interesting. Never heard that term before.
Like they're trying to do the rock soundtrack.
They really are. Dun 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 dun
dun dun dun. They totally are.
Even the modulation. Wow. We want it to sound like this.
Oh. Okay. Like I can do that.
Like this.
Nailed it.
Hell of a scene
Let's
right there.
Begin the briefing. Phantom's assignment is to
Castle Wolfgang.
The CIA.
Okay.
Enigma's Time. Ambitions are night.
Very specific. Enigma's ambitions are global. You have to stop them.
Yeah. Too big of ambitions. Nicholas.
All right, you're a Master Chief. He's like, that's a rank, not a name. Anyway, you're some kind of big space marine. You get woken up at the start of it because the aliens are attacking your ship, and there's an AI lady that lives in the ship, and in 7 years she's going to go crazy. You got to get her, put her in your head, and then you get off and shoot a bunch of guys, and you crash on this ring in space. You're running around the space ring trying to figure out what the fuck the space ring is, and the aliens are using it. Turns out it's a weapon. I don't know.
Hold the square button down. Oh, here we go. Release the button to pull the cord. Yep, I released it. If you open it above 3,000, oh, I need to get in the altimeter thing. Mission over. If you open it too late, you're roadkill. Drew, did you pull the ripcord the times you've gone skydiving?
No.
It's fun. I like pulling the ripcord. Okay.
I've only done tandem.
Oh, okay. Well, I have two. My second time doing tandem, they were like, all right, you're ready to start graduating to where you pull the ripcord.
Oh, cool. Use the left analog
stick to move to the right. Why?
Why what?
Why you gotta move to the right?
Yeah, there's stuff. Just don't hit those lights.
Slack?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
See? Missiles.
Right. Yeah. No. Forget the
storm. Watch the altimeter. Well, I want to dodge these missiles that are coming to my head. Is green good? Yeah, okay, sure.
It's just health kits hanging out at 6,000 feet.
Yeah, you know.
Like a medevac chopper blew up in midair and all the stuff is falling out of it, you know.
Oh, God. Oh, no. Fuck! I got a bandage bomb.
What
the hell is a bandage bomb? Oh, no.
Are you getting there? You got to open between 3,000 and 1,500.
Ow! All right. Let me pull it. Yeah.
No good. You weren't lined up with the target. You're busted.
What?
You lost.
Come on, man. You gotta see what it.
All right.
I want to see what this game is.
I'll try again. It's just this. Is it gonna make me fucking?
Don't. All right, you're dodging stuff.
All right, make sure you line up with the target.
All right.
Target. Target. Target.
I want to get the bandage bombs.
Why?
Forget the storm. Later. Watch the altimeter. I got my eyes right on it. Oh, this is finicky controls. Holy crap. Oh, it's not the same thing every time. There's a grenade that time.
You're almost in range. Get ready to open your chute.
I'm ready.
Does your crosshair have to be on the target?
Oh, maybe.
Perfect. You've got it.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I'm on it. Oh, God. Oh, God. All right. Breaks up the action a bit.
Yeah.
There we go. Snake landing on the tanker.
Great Foley work.
I'm a spy.
Time has come.
Anything my old man was a spy too. Like
you're not a spy. You're just a kid.
I'm ready for it. There's no. We should write a game for me now. Whatever you want. I bet it'd be pretty good. Let's get on with it. Yeah.
Was that it?
Mom taught me to sneeze into my elbow.
Bishop?
I prefer the term artificial person.
I'll go in ahead. You come in behind.
Roger.
I like all back the music in this game.
What?
All
right.
Back in the hole.
You get back in the hole, man.
Big fans of Cool Hand Luke.
Oh, it's Christmas Eve.
Move the camera with the right analog.
Oh, it's inverted. It's all kinds of weird. Oh, yikes.
It's useful for spying.
Press the action button to climb down the ladder.
It's useful for spying. Hey, what's up, man?
Yeah.
Take it.
Yeah. I'll take a mini cam, yeah. Sure. These blow up barrels?
No,
they don't do anything. Jeff, do you ever play PsyOps?
Yeah, PsyOps is a great game.
Yeah, I want to play more of that game. Yep. No one ever talks about PsyOps, and that game's fucking awesome.
Everyone kind of talked about PsyOps for a good long time.
Not where I live. I was the only person that was constantly never shutting up about PsyOps.
Yeah, no,
you can play a Scorpion.
Yep.
With force powers.
Uh-huh. They should have made a sequel to PsyOps.
Yes. The Mind Gate Conspiracy.
If you press and release the triangle button quickly, you can empty your hands or switch between the tools you're using.
That looks really weird to me. So we got first person. Can you shoot? Oh, man.
Yeah, take that.
Metal Gear Killer.
This is after two. It does have the pressure sensitive, like, let up on the button thing. Are these darts or are these kill bullets? Uh-oh. Hellgast.
Yellow.
Enemy soldier ahead.
Use how do you know?
L1
I'm
button
here.
To get past the guards. Press the L1 button to blend into the wall.
Will do.
Oh, yeah.
Does this have, like, octo camo?
I think
the Metal Gear 4 stuff?
That's exactly what it is. Hit it. Or you just press up against it.
It's just the sidle button.
All right. Is that... That's kind of blending into the wall.
Sure. Oh, Drew, you don't know the wonders of octo camo yet. It's good stuff. So am I actually invisible, or is he just gonna look right at me?
Soon enough.
Boy, that's an effective way to do the vision cone thing.
Yeah.
Can I hold him up? Fuck you.
What?
Chip!
What? Let's get him out of here.
Oh god. See, I'm as good at this as I am at Metal Gear.
Safety.
Oh, he's got to test it. Oh, man, it's... Ah.
What?
That's a hell of a jump. Whoa. That's how I get around. This doesn't seem effective at all.
Well, he's wearing a helmet. Shooting silenced bullets at him, you know? It's
trying to let up without shooting. Ah! Alright, Jesus. This looks familiar. I've been here before. Oh shit! He's supposed to break his neck! Yeah! Wow, stars
gun.
And Z's.
He dropped a gun.
Oh? Oh.
Bernou.
I got a Galalimar. How do I pick it? Okay, I can't pull my gun out at all now. Oh, here's my spy tool. All right, well, let's give it a shot. Hey, bud. Yeah! That works a lot better. All right! We're in business.
For 12 more rounds.
There's nothing.
Yeah, there is. Tamara came in. Nope. Wait, that's my buddy.
You're lucky to be alive. Don't get caught. Like
I'm a spy.
That's how it works.
I'll take the lead. You follow.
This is a bad game.
Yeah, it is. I wanted to like it. I didn't. I'm gonna kill one more dude and I'll move along.
It was just kind of like painfully generic in a way.
Yeah.
Like they tried to Oh, maybe that's harsh. Like, they were going for something.
Yeah.
There's more than you can say for a lot of games.
Yeah. I don't want to have to learn how to climb and stuff. We'll just,
What?
All right. I'm getting out of Spy Fiction. How do I... What's moving? Okay. There you go, Drew.
Thank you.
That was Spy Fiction.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I would have been all for, like, a weirder Metal Gear, but... That just wasn't fun to play at all.
Turns out you wanted Metal Gear Solid 4.
Access games.
A weirder Metal Gear.
You think 4 is the weirdest?
No, not... Oh, God.
I mean, 4 builds upon years of weirdness and makes good on a bunch of it, you know?
Yeah.
How do I get out of here?
I'll try all the shoulders and start and select at the same time. Like, all of it.
There we go. Yeah, I know we've talked about it a billion times, but, like, I love that where Drew's head is now after beating Metal Gear 2... And just, like, all those open ends and stuff, like, to tell him that, like, yeah, 4 actually does make good on that. It's kind of a crazy idea.
Good is a relative term, I think. But either way, you should tell everyone that you know more than they do.
That's true. That's
true. Second sight.
Oh, this was... Fuck, what was this?
Psi power.
Yeah, this had, like, telekinesis stuff. This was almost...
Could you, like, possess people and look at things through their perspective? Or something.
I mean, you could do that in PsyOps, I remember. This had TK, like telekinesis, which was always hilarious in PsyOps when you just like took over someone and jumped off a cliff or whatever.
Yep.
I love doing that.
Yep.
Or just throw a wrecking ball into someone's face.
Maybe I'll dig up my copy of PsyOps. We should
yes.
do something with that. Ah, Free Radical.
Oh, right. Wow, the Time Splitters guys.
Yeah. This is beginning to come back to me.
Yeah, dude, bring in PsyOps. I'd love to do a Bombasca or something with it. It takes a while to get all those skills.
It does, yeah.
You get the moving around stuff pretty early, which is fun because you can just like throw scientists into furnaces and stuff early on.
Right, yeah.
Okay. Duly noted.
I didn't know Free Radical did this.
This was their attempt at doing something more than Time Splitters, and if I remember correctly, it didn't. It didn't lead to another one.
I like Time Splitters. I thought those were fun games.
A lot of people liked Time Splitters.
I think it was probably that same generation of people like me that loved GoldenEye and stuff like
I
that.
I liked that they just kind of blew it out and said, like, we're going to, like, your ability to impact the rules and gameplay is going to be unparalleled here.
Oh,
also,
yeah.
You can shoot a monkey, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
There was a certain amount of just, like, fuck it
yeah.
to that.
You're playing really, as a gingerbread man
That
now.
I really, really appreciated.
Yeah. I even remember the, like, level creation stuff being kind of fun. It was a launch game. And it had, like, a full level creation thing that was pretty good.
My favorite gun.
This totally has the visual style of Time Splitters characters, though.
Ground floor.
Inspired by Bioforge.
Hey, stop right there! Hold on.
What are you doing? What's going on?
Whoa. Shut up!
Okay.
Put your hands on the floor.
Let me explain.
Shut up and get down to the ground.
Man, this guy's a dick.
What are you doing? Stop that. Hands on the floor.
Drew, use your second sight. There you go.
Yeah.
Good job, Drew.
Good at this game.
What the hell?
I believe there's some stealth elements in this too. There's a lot of stuff like post Metal Gear, where everyone tried to make their stealth game, their action adventure stealth.
Yeah. It must have. It seems like the first one that people actually really took seriously was Splinter Cell, which I fucking hated Splinter Cell so much.
Yeah, I had no love for the first Splinter Cell.
No. Actually, I didn't like any of them really until what's the one where they drew stuff on the walls in 360?
Yeah, yeah.
Not Black. The one before Blacklist or whatever.
That was a good
Conviction. Conviction. I like that.
Normal operation.
Splinter Cell's just fucking boring. It was all too realistic and way too much just hiding and waiting for light to be right.
Like, there's cool stuff about the setting that I really wanted to like, and you know that type of spy shit. But
Like some of the gadgets were cool as hell, like sticky cameras that you're shooting on the wall and like making noises.
For me, it was just the punishment. You know, the thing that they have bred out of modern stealth games with those, like, the, I'm pulling you out, Sam, you set off too many alarms.
Yeah,
you know, like that.
It's never fun. Oh, Sandy.
A nerd.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, hyper. Yeah, got a hot IRC client. are talking about Battle Tetris.
Did he give me a gun? Stealth.
Stealth, R1 button. You probably have to be close to the wall or something to, yeah.
To stealth?
Kind of looks like that opening trailer of the Phantom Pain before they said it was Metal Gear 5.
Right.
Keeley's show.
Tell that copier to be quiet.
Photocopy your butt.
I don't know how to stand.
Oh.
Oh. There we go. Use computer.
I hate computers.
After dark screensavers.
Not since Doom 3.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man.
Nope. Don't care. What's this? Yeah.
Hey, it's me. Good news travels fast around here.
He's very dangerous should you encounter him.
Hey, it's me.
Sounds like a dangerous man.
I'm a QA guy on the game. I also did the voice. Anyway, see you later.
Damn it. Maybe I can find a computer somewhere else that's allowed to access patient records.
Old video games. Oh, that.
Sure. Nope. Hey, what's in here? Can I go on that?
It's got a read button. Sometimes. Oh, oh.
The colonel called me a doctor, yet I don't recognize any of this at all.
I'm a shitty doctor.
You're like Dr. J.
Ah!
You know?
Or Dr. Death Steve Williams.
Yeah. Or Dr. Mindbender. Actually, Dr. Mindbender would probably help.
Who's that? I don't know that.
It's the Cobra Psycho Anal.
Oh, G.I. Joe?
Yeah. Ah.
Did I actually look at this one, too?
Oh. Dr. Dre. There's a lot of not real doctors.
Mm-hmm.
And there's Dr. Dre, the other Dr. Dre.
Yeah. From the Yo! MTV Raps mm-hmm. one. Yeah. There, Dr. Octagon.
Yeah. Dr. Demento.
Yeah. Dr. Doom.
Dr. Doom with three O's.
My favorite barbecue place in L.A. is Dr. Hoggly Woggly's Tyler, Texas Barbecue.
What?
Yeah.
What
does this place it is an amazing barbecue house? Place in Los Angeles.
I don't get it.
What don't you get?
Dr. Teeth?
What this place has to do with Winter Ice.
Yeah.
Priority one alert. What's Dr. Agent Teeth?
It's the Muppet, the band leader.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And the Electric Mayhem.
Hanoi isn't a name.
Extra security is arriving to deal with the problem.
We're cops. For the laboratory. We're lab cops. Yeah, just shoot him.
Already injured patient. Yeah, use your stealth.
I think they want me to, but... Ow.
This doesn't look good.
You can't see me!
Wait. Wait, what?
Get out!
Okay, alright.
I'm gonna get killed if I hang around here.
How about... What?
What?
Yeah.
Give a gun?
Suck his gun out of his hand.
Yeah. Suck the gun.
What?
Yeah, it's pretty obvious what to do here.
Okay, yeah, do that. That's a shield, probably, right? I don't know. Well, that's also a shield. Here's recycle the batteries.
I don't.
You've got it equipped now, so there's got to be a button to activate it. Try everything.
Uh-oh.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to stalemate here. I should explore.
Explore. This is the time for exploring.
Now, I wouldn't call this a stalemate either.
Yeah, it's pretty one-sided.
You're going to die here.
Yeah.
Dude.
I'm feeling pretty weak.
That's his getting shot.
Perhaps I should try my heal a bit.
My heel? What's my heel?
It's the
ability?
One with the rings around it, I bet. That one.
Healing! Nope.
Oh boy.
I feel sick.
You got a gun?
Oh, God. Whew. Oh, well, I died.
Yes, you did. Free Radical coming 2004.
I'm sure there's a way to play that. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, I kind of want to look it up and see where that game actually goes.
Regardless, you should still tell everyone.
Yeah,
that's true, yeah.
I'll do that.
Get on your Twitter, Drew. Tell everyone.
Mm-hmm. All right. Def Jam Fight for New York.
Oh, yeah. I think this might be the last actual playable demo. Taunt and Blaze is on the right stick.
Okay, yes, you need the Blaze. I forgot. Is this the one that we played recently?
No, we did Vendetta.
We did the other one? Okay.
Yeah.
And Vendetta was the one that came after this?
No, Vendetta was the first one.
Okay.
This is the second one. I want to say this is the one where it wasn't all like in a ring. Like this would be like you're fighting in a basement
yep.
or something.
Yeah.
Oh, because you're hardcore?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like Fight Club.
Strong attack. Block.
Oh, man. And they totally changed the controls. Because, yeah, Vendetta was just straight up no mercy controls.
Yep.
This, they kind of went to their own
punch,
thing.
Kick, strong, grab, throw, pick up, taunt or blaze.
Yeah, you moved a crowd member. It was like an ECW show. Fat fashions.
Like Pit Fighter.
Yeah.
EA Games.
Challenge everything.
God.
What?
This might be a good video.
Is that John Cena?
Hopefully.
Money.
Okay.
Power.
Yeah.
Hustle.
Respect.
Hustle and loyalty.
That's
first.
What the code is all about. Forget the code.
Yep.
Bubba Sparks.
Oh, good. Bubba Sparks.
Is Uncle Cracker in here? Oh, my.
Street fighting.
Myth Bleak.
What was Memphis Bleak's big hit?
Carmen Electra!
I don't remember.
What? Who was Bubba Sparks Miss New Booty? I want to say it was. Or is that... Oh, no, you get to play this. Okay. I think that was Bubba Sparks.
Bubba Sparks did work with Timbaland.
Yeah. Beatbox. Choose the tracks to make you want to fight.
Not available in this demo version.
Enough respect.
Alright.
Don't need any more. It's enough.
Where's my girl at? Where is she?
You won't do any good anyway, man.
Where is she? Come on!
We ain't never gonna let her live anyway, man.
Where is she, man? Tell me!
Is she with my skull?
Yeah. Like this game has Snoop in it, but he's not playing Snoop. He's not playing himself.
Yeah.
Which, you know, when contrasted with all these people who are kind of just playing themselves. I'll be back.
The Method Man?
Yeah.
Well, if it ain't the great fugitive fighter. Sup, champ? See you lost your escorts.
Is he fighting?
I'm just here for the girl, Sticky. And I'm here for you. See, Crow figured this place gonna...
Sticky Fingers wants to burn this building down.
And you two will make it out of here. So I'm making sure...
It's a Carmen Electra.
I believe so.
Beat your ass once and for all. In the ring.
It's not a ring. Burning building. Oh, okay, I see.
Now it's just you and me.
Unlock Johnny Cash if you win this one.
Yeah, okay.
Hold on a sec while we load.
Games back then were way worse about allowing load screens to really break up the flow of cutscenes to gameplay.
I mean, they had to.
Yeah. Well, I liked it better when they would hide stuff, like Metroid Prime, you know, like you'd shoot a door and maybe that door would take a while to open.
They got better at it, you know?
Yeah.
Hero.
Hero and Sticky. Oh.
That's probably bad.
Yeah, you're... Oh, there we go.
Oh no, all on fire!
God, what was the fighting game? It was like an arcade fighting game in the early to mid 90s where they would have like a ring with like electric ropes and you could knock them into it. Oh, fuck, it's gonna drive me nuts.
World Heroes.
World Heroes?
Yeah.
Okay, alright. I remember liking that a lot.
Man.
What do you think, Jeff? How's the feeling?
Now, was the No Mercy engine better than this?
I don't know, I guess. Like, this is kind of the same thing, just they've put, instead of hold down the button for strong, it's just a modifier. So you just are holding down L1 while you hit the strikes for strong strike.
Gotcha.
Which is, you know, like, a little more precise. I'm just having trouble getting any grabs off. I'm trying to grab them.
Nope, just... Hey, there we go. It's gonna punch you into fire.
Come on, say something now.
I'm sorry, what? It's like that. Better.
That's the best way to end a demo.
Flav of Flav. Busta Rhymes?
Yeah, he was in the story bit there at the beginning.
All right.
Oh, boy.
Tell everyone that you know more than they do.
By the way, Dan, that wrestling game counts about.
Oh, you're talking about an actual wrestling game?
No, I'm thinking about a fighting game.
Yeah.
This is a fighting game, but wrestling characters.
Because World Heroes had deathmatch mode where it had the spikes on the walls and the electric ring and the fire on the ring.
That is definitely what I'm thinking of, yeah. Although I'd like to look up what you're talking about, Jason, because that sounds cool. I probably would.
It's, yeah, 3 Count Bout's kind of cool.
Here's Neo Contra, which I played a few years ago, actually, maybe 2 years ago, and it's better than I think people gave it credit for.
Hmm.
44.
It's a lucky
year. Is that a year or the number to a cab company?
Samurai Kano.
Yeah, it's a weird perspective for Contra, but it actually plays pretty well. Oh, yeah, you get these weird robot raptors.
Hey.
Riser.
Oh, weird.
But I remember going... I remember going kind of overhead for most of the non, like, stunty boss fight stuff here. Samurai Kano.
In this one, you're fighting player 2 from the original Contra, aren't you?
Is he the bad guy?
Is he the bad guy?
Oh, man, I didn't
I want to say that became part of the Contra fiction at some point.
The Lance?
Where Bill and Lance had to throw down.
Yeah, so you're Bill and Samurai dude here.
Yeah.
And so Lance, maybe,
Maybe he's the boss? I don't know.
All right, it's a samurai on an airplane. That's cool.
Again, I could be making all that up.
Are they running on helicopter blades?
Yeah, they are.
That's pretty great.
That's fucking amazing.
You can't do that. It'd be real hard.
Oh, well, I mean, I don't know that I would say you can't.
I've never tried it. Yeah, this is all pretty cool stuff.
I mean, it doesn't look like it's that much fun to play, but
I remember it not being terrible. I remember it had terrible ads or terrible box art with some crazy baby looking thing. Seems Japanese as shit.
Back when Japan was doing what Japan, only Japan could do.
Yeah. I miss that.
Yeah.
How long is this trailer?
It's a lot of ground to cover here, Drew. That's cool.
I'm sorry, what?
Yeah, because all the bosses, their last names, I want to say, were Contra. There was, like, Flower Contra, or, like, Plant Contra. And
you're like Bill Sandinista.
It's a pretty cool trailer. Yep, all right. All right. I'm on board.
Available soon.
All right. Check out Nocturne.
Oh, is this Shin Megami Tensei?
Oh, I have no idea.
Like SMT Nocturne?
That is a series I know nothing about.
Yeah.
It's weird.
It's subjective.
Alright, this music's pretty cool. Is it?
Yeah, oh yeah. Born again demon.
What does Shin Megami Tensei translate to?
Super party machine.
Mr. Grimm?
Yeah, I mean, so, I mean, yeah, the Shin Megami Tensei series is where Persona came from.
Oh.
Persona is an SMT offshoot.
I see, okay. Dante?
Yes.
What?
Also, okay. Also, that I think that actually is Dante.
That super looked like Dante.
There, I want to say there might have been some weird crossover in this game. I can't remember.
The dual guns and the red jacket and the white hair.
Yeah, it is Dante. They have a credit there.
Oh, wow.
DMC2, so.
Oh, DMC2, Jesus. Sweet!
Yeah!
Oh, was this the weird offshoot thing where they tried to make it more arcadey?
Was this NASCAR Rumble? Oh no!
Remember Rumble Racing?
Yeah,
Rumble Racing and NASCAR
Rumble. Those were both great games.
Yep.
They were like the Hot Wheels games. You know? Do all the stunts and shit.
Yeah,
really cool. I played Rumble Racing last year for a little while.
Really?
Yeah.
I remember being real good.
It had not aged super well.
Oh yeah. Is this fucking Buck Cherry or something?
I mean, probably. A safe bet.
For Godsmack. 2005, Chase for the Cup. Do you remember the big rumor in high school was that it was Snake, David Hayter, doing the voice of like EA Sports. It's in the game.
Really?
Which it totally sounds like him.
Yeah.
And we saw the champions one of the
top. Oh, yeah, we saw that. Okay.
It is not.
No.
No.
This game was weird.
They're all weird.
Are any of them good?
I think people like them a lot.
Yeah.
I'm not the guy for this.
Here's the thing. I appreciate some of the things like 2 did. I think 2 is the one that people look at a lot, like being awesome. It did some cool things, but the actual gameplay, I just remember walking down these giant hallways with 8,000 doors that look the same.
And
you just have to hit X on every one of them and be like, that door's locked, that door's locked. But like, you can't go back to it.
Sounds like some Steam games I played.
Oh, I think I've watched you play some of those. This one, they tried something different, to where like this room was like your hub, and it kept getting more and more like hellish or whatever. That said, I am really looking forward to whatever the fuck Kojima and Guillermo del Toro do with the new one.
Dan, I think you're not covering up your mic, you're just piping the sound from your mouth to the microphone.
Just mainlining the straight
magnifying
there.
Magnifying the cough sound.
Like that, we now have like 3 straight weeks of content with me coughing over it. That's fun for everyone.
You should probably stop sleeping in coal mines.
Sleep in a nice bed.
In a coal mine?
Well, yeah, I mean, nice bed that counteracts the coal.
Oh.
Everyone knows that. I remember the first Silent Hill was pretty cool for its time, because post Resident Evil, everything was going for like the jump scares, like dog jump through the window type stuff. And Silent Hill was very much this like unsettling psychological scares, which I appreciated.
Different, and that's cool. But it was just one of those things, like as someone who didn't really like the type A survival horror, the kind of type B survival horror didn't really do it for me either.
Yeah, I'm the same way.
I really like their enemy designs.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and 2 with the nurses and crap. Yeah, it was super, super creepy.
There's no one in those wheelchairs. Or is there?
I think I appreciate Resident Evil for what it is. I just never really had that much fun playing them.
Yeah.
Until 4. 4 and 5. It's a weird trailer.
I kind of came in with to Resident Evil with the context of having played Alone in the Dark a fair amount, which did that first.
Oh, see, I never touched those.
And really liked the first Alone in the Dark. But yeah, I just never...
No, I know Alone in the Dark had PlayStation versions, but was it mostly a PC game?
Yeah.
Okay. God, they made a movie of that with Christian Slater and Tara Reid, didn't they?
They did.
Wow.
They made a Silent Hill movie, too, didn't they?
Yeah, with Sean Bean. I want to say Tara Reid played a scientist in the Alone in the Dark movie.
Did Sean Bean play Pyramid Head?
What?
That's
I thought he was
guy.
The dad.
I don't know.
I know Pyramid Head is, but I thought he was the dad that went missing or whatever, and his kids had to go find him or something.
I don't know the plot of the Silent Hill movie. Stop talking to me.
Well, that was a video on our side.
I've heard that sentence. What's going on in this trailer? That doesn't happen.
This is dumb.
Yeah, it's real dumb.
It's like this was kind of cool for a while, and then at some point it crossed the line. Like, yeah, I get it. All right, it's unsettling. There's no one in the wheelchairs. I'll talk about horror. Talk about the Sleepaway Camp films. Now you're talking.
The what?
Sleepaway Camp.
What is that?
A series of movies. They're fun.
Was that a movie where somebody threw a football that turned into a screw and it went through a cheerleader's head?
That seems like something that might have happened in one of those.
Because I remember seeing, I think it was called Sleepaway Camp when I was like 6 years old, and it's scarring me because it was like pretty violent. And that sounds about right.
In one of them, they buried a guy up to his head and then took a lawnmower and put it down his head.
That'd be no fun.
Yeah, probably not.
All right, that was a stupid trailer.
Yep. What we got? Call of Duty?
Call of Duty.
Call of Maybe you've heard Duty. Of it. Finest Hour. This is before Call of Duty was Call of Duty.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, it was really popular during this era of Call of Duty, but like the stuff they were putting on the console was kind of like unique to it. It was like Big Red 1 this.
Which never like, you know, the acclaim that the PC stuff got. It was never really matched on the consoles.
Right. Well, Call of Duty 2 launched on the Xbox 360.
Sure. That was the one that got me in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then 3 I thought was bad.
3 sucks.
I didn't like 3.
The stupid like close quarter stuff.
Yeah, 3 was the game where you were like, man, fuck Treyarch.
Yeah. And then over the course of a few games.
And then World of War you were like, no, I meant it. Like, fuck Treyarch.
And then Black Ops.
Like, this game's all right, but.
Yeah. People were so pissed at World of War just because like, god damn it, give us more modern stuff now. That's okay. I appreciate the brevity of that one.
Yeah. Some World War II shit, Finest Hour.
I just want to watch Enemy at the Gates.
I've never seen that.
Oh, you should see that.
I think Harry Gregson Williams has the soundtrack.
Spark.
Mr. Metal Gear. Speaking of Metal Gear. So, Drew.
So, Dan.
I'm guessing, I think based on this being 2004, because it came out in 2005? No, actually, this might be the longer E3 one. If that's the case, this is a pretty sweet trailer.
Okay.
There was a teaser one the year
should
before.
Should I watch it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, again, this is prequel stuff, so I mean, it can't really ruin anything. Okay. And so we'll do this in
lieu. And this will be stuff that anyone going into Metal Gear Solid 3 would have seen in that era.
I had watched every Metal Gear 3 trailer, not kidding, hundreds and hundreds of times before playing Snake Eater.
Lunatic.
God, I'm so excited. I think this might be the one where you actually see some characters and stuff. The first one was just kind of teaser gameplay stuff, him hanging from a tree, him eating a snake.
Wait, he eats snakes in this?
Yeah.
For health.
Spoilers.
Yes! Oh, this game's awesome. Oh, the song. It's so fucking good. I think this might be the first one.
Also, predators in it. Spoilers.
Well, this game's fucking awesome.
A lot of guns in it.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is like kind of a dumb trailer so far because it's just him shooting dudes.
That's. I mean, this
in a way that like has. Yeah.
And then Metal Gear.
And then it Metal Gears up a little bit.
No, this was that initial, like, not a lot happens in this trailer. Certainly no story stuff.
Yeah.
Just, it gives you a sense of the setting, which is pretty fucking awesome. Yes! Oh wait, don't cut off the part where they do the super sweet acoustic version of the theme. Fuck you! That's the best part of that trailer! Oh, I gotta send you that, Drew. Damn it, all right. It's so cool.
Well, all right. Too bad we're not doing that series anymore, Dan.
Nope, that's all done forever, right?
What's
good
under
Lord.
Extras? What's under extras?
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Oh, okay.
Boy. Is this the girl from the Playboy Mansion that's like, I'm a super gamer junkie?
No idea.
God damn.
Who is that guy?
The gamer.
Okay.
Let's settle down the Adobe After Effects here.
No, she's a former quality assurance analyst.
Hi.
My name's Sandra, and I work in Format QA. I test video games.
I also sing for No Doubt.
Does my belt look cool? Cool, huh?
Yep, it's got a star on it.
Kami.
What is testing mean? What does that mean?
I play through the games and look for bugs in them so consumers don't get crashes when they play the games. I get to play a lot of video games before they come out, before the public gets to see them, so like months ahead of time. And they get free games. I think the worst kind of bug is like a binary crash bug, which is basically something that every time you do a certain thing, it crashes.
Her name's really familiar.
I can't
figure out why.
Like
racking my brain.
Not ringing a bell to me.
It depends on the game. It happens a lot in like third-person shooters. One way I find them is like to go to the end of the level, like an exit door or something, and like die right as you're exiting, so the next level loads, but you're dead, and it says press start to restart the level, you press start, and it just loads you as being dead, and it says that over and over again, and you can't do anything, so you're screwed. As a lead tester,
gets drunk at the office a lot while the contract guys do the work.
And like basically break down all the parts of the testing process.
But he's not even hitting the things.
Well, they're testing it. They have to test it for all circumstances, man.
Wow, Nick, great job. Sabo, come on, show a little more enthusiasm.
Tighten up the graphics on level 3. What are we?
I think it's more fun to be a lead just because I like being like organized and responsible and I like being in charge.
Like bossing people around?
No. Dude, seriously, I told you to check over the report before you put it in the database. Not really though, because I'm so nice. So.
You're holding two gun cons?
We have fun around here.
It's not some stuffy office environment. Oh, boy. What?
Alan just asked me one day if I had any cool moves, and I mean, I found one and just told him. He's like, okay, you're going over here at 2 o'clock. I'm like, okay. By the way, don't feel my feet. Everybody makes fun of my toes. They say I can play piano with them.
Seems like this should be from 1996. Is this what it was like back then?
Hi, my name's Sandra
in
Mitchell,
2004?
I don't remember things being like this in 2004.
See? It's all the 90s.
Hi, my name's Sandra Mitchell,
everything before like 2009 was the 90s.
Again, I don't think this is how calendars
like,
work.
Until everything went 16:9, it was still the 90s.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know. It's pretty easy now because I'm comfortable around everybody. But when I first did it, I was like a robot. I'm like, hi. Sandra Mitchell, cool move.
So, you know, we got a lot of these frizzies. Your hair, it's just...
The cameraman, Lenny, is almost
not his real name.
In a bad mood, so, makes the guys cry.
We call
when
him Lenny.
Do cool moves, so. Oh my god, you're my best friend.
That was dope.
Except I did some weird eyebrow thing. I'm like...
I know. Can you do it without... Like,
I got something in my eye.
Why do you capitalize cool move?
Because it's from the cool moves section.
Oh, that's okay. Sorry. Silly thing.
Cool move that I did. How to like not have the sniper shoot at you because basically there's two entrances to this building where the sniper is.
What
and he's either
that?
In this window
Siphon
or
filter?
This window.
Yes.
If you walk around
but
to one
maybe.
Window
thinking,
let him like see you just
what were they doing in like 2004?
And then go all the way around
filter.
The town.
Oh, right. I guess, yeah.
That was my first thought too. It looked like the camera perspective looks like.
It looked like the legs.
Yeah.
Swimmy legs.
Yeah.
Hey, Sandra. How do you get Mary-Kate and Ashley out of the shopping mall?
You have to buy the pink, sparkly outfit.
Hey, Sandra. I can't stop my guy from dying when he falls off the cliff.
Don't fall off the cliff.
Good advice.
Hey, this PS2 thing, does it have an on button?
Just stick your hand behind there and press a bunch of stuff. It'll go on.
Hey, Sandra, where's the bathroom again?
Just go in your cube. You don't have time. You need a test.
This is my bad side. Just kidding.
Boy.
She appears to still work for Sony in format QA.
Really?
She's a supervisor.
I mean, she was at that point, too. Yeah.
I guess we're doing track Gran Turismo 4, whatever that is. Wait, do we have to play? Is this just like a track? Oh, Christ.
These get longer and longer.
I know. Wait, we got to go back in time for the next one.
Hey, those are still nice looking car models.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As it turns out.
They always like nailed it.
That's still a really nice looking video game right
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
You know what it is also? It's the frame rate and it's the camera movement.
Yep.
Yeah.
Not enough games pay attention to camera movement.
Yeah.
Madden is particularly bad at this.
Yeah.
Like, I've railed about this before, but like, yeah, your graphics can look all nice and whatever, but like when your camera locks onto the XYZ 000 point of the player's head, it just tracks it, it doesn't look real.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Can I skip this?
Yeah.
I propose this to the jury.
I remember this
looking
so awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Before it came out.
This, like, still looks great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like those people getting out of the way.
Yeah, they've always been at the forefront of this type of stuff.
I never much cared for playing them.
I like 3 a lot. 3's the only one I put a lot of time into.
I bought the wheel with 3, and that was the one where I really gave it my all. And
yeah.
And tried to get into it, and yeah, like kind of. That's when I started, like, I think respecting the series,
yeah,
in a big way.
I mean, they do great work.
Yeah,
it's for a crowd though that is not me.
Playing Forza actually put me in a position where I was able to play and enjoy Gran Turismo more.
Oh, yeah,
just by, you know, by it being a better teacher of the basic mechanics of driving.
Why was that in a different section than the
Look,
other videos?
It's a big deal.
All right. All right, last one.
This
here we go.
Here we go. PlayStation Underground at E3. This would have been 2 years before I was ever there, so I'm curious to see this. Oh, good Lord. Fuck.
Okay. This is the gaming advisory panel. So this is like
Christ.
Them inviting people off the streets, right?
I have no idea.
Was your first one 06, Dan?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, me too.
Yeah, yeah. That was a big one.
Yeah.
3 and Wii.
Mm-hmm. I missed 07. PlayStation
Gamer That's, that one sucked.
Yeah.
That was the one in Santa Monica with all the airport hangars or whatever.
We were running a show off of the Santa Monica Pier in 07, so I only went to the airplane hangar to play Burnout. And then, so I just went there, played it, and then turned around, got in a cab, and left.
Okay.
Because everyone was bringing their games to us on the pier.
It's a good spot to be in.
Yeah, it was awesome. So if you don't
give it to me, this was GameSpot days, right?
Yep.
Yeah, because that's right, because it was the next E3 where I met you in 08, and you had just started this.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. My Mr. Clean, I'm gonna make it smooth. I am Bob Lauberman. Send me to E3 because I've got nothing else to do and nowhere else to go. Bob Lauberman is a registered trademark, some assembly required, wife and baby not included. Thank you. Oh,
it's like light
camera action. That kid doesn't have a chance.
Go. You know what I'm saying? Let's go. If y'all keep, y'all gotta keep up with me. I don't have to keep up with you. You know what I'm saying? True.
To earn a chance to arrive in style at the mecca of the gaming
World
world,
Combat Deception, yeah.
Center,
you had to bring something creative.
It's fucking awesome.
It was a full-on show, matching wits, determination, and passion about gaming.
These look like gamers.
I've got a top 10 reasons of why I should get to come to this show on Sony's dime.
I did a PowerPoint presentation. I made it like a dating simulation.
My entry was an essay. I wrote about the Gamer Advisory Panel.
I think I was selected to attend E3 because I'm exciting, I'm energetic, plus y'all need somebody that looks good on the camera, you know what I'm saying?
If you want more info on who won and how, plus some other fun stuff, check it all out
Places
in the
underground
section on this disc.
I forgot they are.
Underground.
Expectations were as high as the energy level when our participants got ready to go.
This is my first time at E3, and I am just pumped. I can't tell you, I feel like a kid at Disneyland.
And I have, like, been so stoked about this.
Go to E3.
Just track these people down 10 years later.
That'd be fascinating.
Ridiculously excited to be here.
That guy grew up to be Steve-O.
About what was coming up next. A friendly competition that would demonstrate the breadth of their knowledge.
Jackass probably like off the air.
That's what I'm even mentioned for.
Well, the first thing we're going to do with you guys, we're going to do a little scavenger hunt. Put you in two teams. And Bob, you're a team captain.
After selecting captains and choosing one team member to wear the helmet cam, the
I can see why. I mean, the first time you go to E3 is exciting as shit.
Yeah.
Like, I remember being just thrilled in 06.
Yep. PlayStation booth at E3.
It is still exciting.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's always fun.
Go.
That's what I want on the show floor at E3.
Tony Shalhoub.
People screaming, Tony Shalhoub.
And have another team member take a picture of the fastest group time you can get. Follow the glowing pen.
Guys, the Sony booth is not that big. This will be an easy scavenger hunt.
I'm trying to see. Is that 25 to life behind him? That was.
Go like this, break in a photo finish. Who wants to do that?
Boy, I don't like that guy.
Bye, we're going.
According to Greek mythology, Ares was the God of War.
Oh shit, is this from God of War was there?
All right, I'm gonna put the camera here. You guys just run up and check
out. No golf in Japan. That's Hot Shots Golf 4, and that's our final answer. Moving on.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Write it over to the PSP and read it for our camera crew. Now, Haiku is 575. So small, a cutie, you can hold it in your hand. Plays games and movies.
Oh boy.
That's so bad. We got it.
Son, I can't be second, son. That's Team Pesci, son. This is Team Pesci.
He's positive. Victor will be silent. Transformers, more than meets the eye.
This team better
lose.
What
are we doing?
I'm going for this team.
Why? Why?
What? They move, they Transformers, yeah.
Cassie, your favorite face game.
Yep, that's the theme song.
Exhibit a PS2 game.
Yes.
E3's great.
MTV Cribs cameras.
Yeah.
What is happening?
Excuse me, sir. Could you take a picture of us in front of this? Thank you.
You guys GameStop managers or what?
Get it? Good.
The two teams gave everything they had to pull together and finish all their tasks.
I don't
the
care!
The hands of our able judges to determine the winner.
In the back of our booth, job. In this hot fucking room.
One team, however, did a slightly better job. And you made it very difficult for us. We agonized over the pictures.
They were all very good.
So the winning team in this year's Gamer Advisory Panel Scavenger Hunt is the black t-shirt.
Yeah! Whoa.
They're doing
Booker T stuff?
I believe so.
Waiting for the spinner Rudy.
You get hats.
You guys have to leave E3 immediately.
The armed guards.
Oh yeah, bonus!
Crazy, it was so much fun. We got to run around.
Yeah!
A bunch of people, get them off games.
Oh, Burnout 3, damn it.
Yo, it's such a good game.
The most difficult was probably
Sly 2?
Gran Turismo 4 one because I
is that late?
Kept crashing into the walls. In fact, I didn't make one turn.
Now, I'm going to say the most humorous question was the Transformers question, getting everybody to sing together.
That is quite humorous.
Probably the most humorous.
You need like
it was questions. It was quite humorous, I have to say.
Watching Bob dance through the Dance Dance Revolution on the eye toy thing, because he doesn't got moves. He's not, dancing's not his thing, so it's kind of funny watching
him. Groove thing is being shaken.
rhythm. I can't hear what I'm dancing to.
That's the proper E3 experience of playing a DDR game there. Like you're just fucking stepping on going, I can't fucking hear a thing.
So it's never too early to start thinking about how you're going to get the nod to represent the gap at next year's E3.
Oh, man. Got to start working on our audition tapes.
Yeah.
Speaking of which.
No! No! Oh, man.
It's me. All right, let's go. Basically, you have 2 minutes to tell us why you should be the host of OPM and represent the Gamer Advisory Panel at E3.
E3?
Poor OPM.
And that's why I want to go, because I know what's involved.
I think last year I actually drove around asking people, can I have your pass for the next day? Can I have
that's
your pass
good
for the
approach.
Next day?
I've really been trying to get back to E3. Kissing a lot of butts, but lately, I've just saw my lips have pretty much.
That guy's been there before.
Chapstick,
so. I'm just trying to get back to E3.
Brad DeMoss here again. I'm sure all of you remember me from last year. Well, I'm back.
The first time was a disaster. It was a crash and burn. However, I've been watching a lot of American Idol, and I'm Clay Aiken of E3.
Stop this video. You need to turn this off.
No, I'm keeping this controller close to my chest.
Damn it.
Nobody's touching this. I know, I do too.
We need to go home.
We're done at 7 o'clock.
Yeah, I
know. Jason, I'm sorry.
Prepared. You need to appreciate these folks getting their break in the industry.
As far as preparing for this, no, I didn't. I won't lie to you. No.
No, not really.
Nothing really.
Honestly, I didn't know about anything about impressing the judges. I don't want to impress the judges. I just want to be myself.
I prayed.
It is taking everything I have not to make fun of these people.
I know.
And here with me is my friend Gollum from Lord of the
Rings. Oh, please.
The fools.
I think I made a fool of myself.
I can do a car.
Nailed it. He's in. Send him to E3.
Skate real fast and be in a split and then turn around and go in straight into a split, or I can roll over backwards to a split. I'm talking about on my skates now.
Do you want to get your badge for E3? You got to show how good you are doing.
No, that's what I had to do. I
kind of got lost. Doesn't bode well, does it?
Cool.
I've never done it before.
The triangle, the square, and the X. We're gonna do it. We're gonna be at E3. We're gonna hit it. This is the GSP.
This isn't real.
I'm gonna have sex with the triangle and the X.
You that? Can I do it over? Video game gives me direction and
a raging erection.
I can escape reality's problems.
I mean, I came.
Yeah.
Hopefully I conquered.
I represent one of
the his mouth is literally just wide open. It's great.
Within gaming, and that's gamers that are over 40. We need to develop games for the geriatric crowd, which I'm going to be part of
Jack
very, Trent's very soon.
Nephew.
I have enthusiasm. I can barely stand still. Standing inside this tea thing that you guys can see is a problem for me. So you can imagine what I'm going to be at E3, bouncing around the walls.
Stop.
Yep, send him to E3.
No.
You're in.
Sweet Caroline. Bah, bah, bah.
I think I did really well in that interview. A few people were left dead, but the decision has been made. I'm going to E3.
Those are the winners?
Hang on, no, I think we're about to see the winners. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, come on. Let's say glorious. John Beaverly. Stories from PlayStation.com.
No!
Oh no! 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 No!
We have to stop.
I can't.
We have to stop.
Okay, let's do the minimum required thing here. I'm Jeffrey. Okay.
I can't stop clapping.
I know. All right, we watched that Area 51 thing. Oh yeah, they tried to remake Area 51, and then it sucked. All right, LucasArts.
Yep. No, we should save this for next time and really delve into this stuff.
All right, this might be it. Well, hang on. Let's at least finish the national winners and the contestant slideshow. Just finish that. Oh, my God. Hang on.
Some people might say that I get a little too into my gaming, you know? But I don't think so.
I've been a hardcore gamer for about 18 years now, and I find that it's much more fun to try to bring as much of my gaming life into my everyday activity as I possibly can.
The best!
I've had years and years of experience. I've played every game ever for now. By picking me over everyone else, you're not just getting the hardcores to hardcore gamers, and you're not only a good guy, you're also getting all this. A dancer. An entrepreneur. An interviewer. A gangster. A rice counter. A TV VCR repairman. A world-famous supermodel. A bed diver. A plumber. And a kung fu expert. But wait, there's more.
I bought the
eye
toy. I think legally you have to send me to E3 now.
His badge came in every box.
I think I have enough experience. I've always gotten very excited about video games. Some might say too excited, but I think that'll make me an even better correspondent.
What the fuck is that picture?
To represent Sony and the Gamer Advisory Panel at E3 will be both an honor and a privilege. I have long been a fan of Sony's high-quality gaming consoles and products, and I can't wait to see what they got ready for this fall. To actually report on it for Sony would be an honor. I can't
report.
Wait to see what E3's got to hold,
yeah,
and to be there in person would be absolutely awesome.
Just zoom in on that nose.
I mean, how can you not choose me? Seriously, though, I bring a unique style, plenty of enthusiasm, and a ton of experience to the job, as well as my winning smile. Whatever you choose, thank you for considering me, and I hope to see you at E3. Da-da-da-da!
My new desktop wallpaper. Oh, how many of these are there? Oh my god! Okay. Do we save these all? This is golden stuff. Should we save it? Oh, what's
yeah,
happening?
Yeah, we need to see all of these, and I can't watch them right now.
Yeah, yeah, okay. So we gotta remember, we've obviously watched that guy.
Let's start doing these at 10 a.m. instead of so late in the day.
Yeah.
Because some of these, eventually one of these is gonna take all day.
7 p.m.
Yeah. We got a slideshow. Uh-huh. ATV Off-Road Fury 3. Some pretty good stuff here. Getaway. Yep, good stuff. Yeah, he made it.
Yeah, he's a gamer.
Sure, PS something. Yep, sure.
He's PC.
It's just auto-scrolling now. All right. Yeah, look at the snake. It looks like he's shooting him. That's wacky. All right, we are going to return to this. We have to watch this other audition. I don't know if any of
I have to know more about these people.
They can't top Paul Delia's. I'm looking him up on Twitter. His full name is on here. I'm looking up Paul Delia.
Maybe a misstep.
All right.
So stories from PlayStation.com and National Winners.
Oh,
right?
Joseph. I'm looking up Joseph Delia. Jason, there's your thumbnail.
No, I think it was
remember the USA one.
Or the gangsta.
Yeah. Okay, we gotta wrap this up.
I never should have let you guys rope me into this.
Welcome, Jeff.
It's a rabbit hole.
To our nightmare.
All right, Jeff and Drew.
Okay.
We're not done, but we're done for this one.
Thanks.
Thanks for joining me.
Thanks, Sony. It's been an honor.